week. We hope we can match up a little bit better just because they're more of a spread, but they have a really tough run game. Even though they're in that spread, they want to run the ball.
Pocahontas area coach Mike Ains says turnovers in this game will be crucial.
We have not won the turnover battle all year in our first four games, and that's something we've been trying to get better at. And we've got to take care of the football, and we've got to be able to force some turnovers, I think, and that's going to be a key, I think. Other than that, we probably both match up pretty well.
East Sac has intercepted 11 passes on the season, tied for second in the state. Pocahontas area and East Sac County meeting on the gridiron for the first time in 3 years, both looking for their first district win. Pokies won 5 of the previous 7 meetings. For the scouting report from Storm Lake, I'm Ryan Thompson.
Also in 1A tonight, it's 3rd-ranked Underwood hosting Shenandoah. 4th-ranked Iowa City Regina is at Cascade. Two of the unbeatens in 2A District 1 collide as 4th-ranked Western Christian hosts number 3 West Lyon. Doug Brook has a preview.
Both teams are 4-0 coming into the game. Western Christian coach Travis Coima says it's exciting to be involved in a game like this.
It's a great test of, you know, are we able to match the physicality of a very physical team? Are our guys ready to focus all week in practice to prepare the way you have to prepare to be able to win a big football game? All that stuff gets thrown into this week, and that's exciting. I love our guys' approach so far this week. It was great. And then we'll just see if we can execute and perform tonight.
West Lyon coach Jay Rosenbaum says Western Christian has talent all over the field.
Very impressive football team, offense, defense, special teams, and very, very well coached.
The other unbeaten team in Class 2A District 1, second-ranked Central Lyon George Little Rock, faces a rated matchup at number 10 Cherokee tonight. For the Radio Iowa Scouting Report, I'm Doug Brute.
2A top-ranked Van Meters at home against Clark, and an 8-player tonight. It's number 1 Gladbrook Rhinebeck hosting Janesville. Second-ranked Winfield Mount Union is at home against English Valleys. That's all for the scouting report. For Radio Iowa Sports, I'm Todd Kim.
Game on.
The game. One game.
Sioux County Radio takes you live to the gridiron.
Take the field. Let's go. Let's go.
High school football is on the air.
Set for high school football on this Friday evening, a little bit earlier kickoff than usual due to the possibility of thunderstorms this evening. But we should have a good matchup as the Sioux Center Warriors in their homecoming game playing host to Sioux City Heelan. Sioux Center coming in 3-1 after 3 straight wins in non-district play over Spirit Lake, Unity Christian, and Spencer. The lone loss for the Warriors in week 1 to Class 2A 3rd-ranked West Lyon. Sioux City Heelan, meanwhile, comes in unbeaten. They are 4-0 in their 4 non-district games. A earned win over Carroll Kemper, Council Bluffs Abe Lincoln, Sioux City East, and Sioux City West. Heelan, a team that went just 2-7 a year ago, tied for 4th in 3A District 1 with Carroll with the 2-3 records. Sioux Center, meanwhile, the district champion a season ago after going 4-1 in the district and 5-5 overall. Sioux Center won this matchup in Class 3A District 1 last season by a score of 29-7. It's the district opener tonight for both teams. Figures to be a good matchup. Heelan comes in 4-0, ranked number 4 in Class 3A in both the Radio Iowa and the AP polls. Looking at a quick look at some of the numbers, Heelan comes in at scoring 39.3 points a game, averaging 364 yards a game total offense, 103 yards passing, 261 yards a game rushing. Defensively, the Crusaders allowing just 15 points a game, giving up 251.3 yards a game in total offense, 169 yards passing, and a stingy run defense that's allowed only 82.5 yards per game rushing. Sioux Center will counter with a rushing attack that's averaging 206.8 yards a game. The Warriors averaging 311.5 yards a game in total offense, scoring 30 39 points a game. The Warrior defense holding teams to 14 points a game, limiting their opponents to 173.8 yards a game in total offense, 104 yards through the air, just 69.8 yards per game rushing allowed by this Warrior defense. Peyton Work joins me on tonight's broadcast. Should be a fun night. Looks like a good matchup.
Yeah, homecoming game for Sioux Center. Probably the biggest regular season game for both of these teams in quite a few seasons now. Heelan ranked number 4, as you said, in both the Radio Iowa and AP poll. Sioux Center ranked number 9 in the AP poll. And on paper, these two teams are basically identical in terms of yardage on both offense and defense. So it figures to be a very good matchup tonight.
Defensively, both teams not giving up much rushing yards. Offensively, both teams want to establish that running game first and foremost.
Yeah, both teams have fairly balanced offenses, I'd say, but they're run first offenses, both of them. And yeah, Heelan putting up 260 yards per game on the ground, and Sioux Center putting up 200 yards per game on the ground. So whichever team is able to establish the run game first, I think is the one that will be able to put up more points and sustain longer drives here tonight.
Heelan quarterback Quinn Olson, two-time All-District selection, 8 passing touchdowns. He's also rushed for 200 yards. Dual threat there that the Warrior defense has to be aware of.
Yeah, Olson, a very talented quarterback, and he's also averaging over 10 yards per passing attempt coming into the season, which is very efficient for a high school quarterback.
The Warriors will counter with the solid rushing attack, kind of a triple-headed monster with Connor Cameron, Seth Anderson, and Solomon T.
Yeah, for the Warriors, whenever one running back gets tired, they're able to just sub him out and bring in another one, and that's why they've been able to sustain some really long drives this season rushing the ball, and they've been able to rush the ball deep into the game and into the fourth quarter.
And Carson Brune is a tough matchup for anyone.
Yeah, the Kansas University commit, 6'6", 240, runs a 24-second 200. He can move, he can catch the ball, and he can block.
Should be a fun night of football. Homecoming at Open Space Park for the Sioux Center Warriors, who are hosting the Crusaders of Bishop Heelan District Opener in Class 3A District 1. I visited earlier with both Sioux Center coach Tim Van Regenmorter and Heelan coach John LaFleur. We'll hear what the head coaches had to say after this two-minute break. You're listening to High School Football on Sioux Ritmo 101.5.
There's a lot.
American State Bank is celebrating our 50th anniversary, and we couldn't have made it this far without your support. For us, banking just scratches the surface. We pride ourselves in our commitment to our communities, building meaningful relationships with our customers, and doing our best to have some fun along the way. We're proud to be a locally owned and operated bank, supporting the communities we serve. Thank you for choosing American State Bank. We can't wait to see what the next 50 years have in store.
I stumbled across X-ray and did some research about how you can change modalities and you can do all these different opportunities, and I just thought that was really awesome. And NCC had amazing graduation rates, they had great reviews, so that's why I chose NCC.
So we welcome you to come to NCC and be a part of the engineering design tech programs, and you know, find your passion for a career choice in manufacturing in Northwest Iowa.
Today's banking is about so much more than numbers. It's about people. It's about community. It's about the next generation. Banking is personal. That's what we believe. And that's why we'll always put you first. Northwest Bank. Commitment you can bank on.
A trip to Pizza Ranch feels just like going home.
Hi, welcome to Pizza Ranch.
You can find all your favorite foods just the way you like them. Where a smile lets you know you're always welcome. And you're made to feel like family. For legendary service and a little slice of heaven, it's Pizza Ranch for the win.
Thank you.
Sioux Center coach Tim Van Regenmorter joins me on tonight's pregame show. And a good road win for the Warriors last week in your final non-district contest, 35-14 at Spencer. Great start to the game for the Sioux Center.
Yeah, you know, it really was. We played really well in the first half there, especially, you know, on offense. We were able to get a stop on defense and then drive the field and punch one in, and our special teams executed. We get a turnover on kickoff and find ourselves up 14-0 pretty fast in that game. So it was fun to start fast. It's something we hadn't done all year, so it's good to see us do that on the road.
And defensively, didn't give up anything. Spencer's only score in that first half came on a long kickoff return.
Yeah, you know, we played really well. We got the ball back into our offense's hands. And the result is, you know, we complement each other really well, give our offense more opportunities, and find ourselves up 35-7 at half.
The offense, the ground game was outstanding with 260 yards led by Connor Kammerman and Solomon T.
Yeah, both those guys had big games. And, you know, offensive line-wise, we opened up some good holes. And Spencer made no bones about it. They were going to put 8 in the box, and we were still able to get 5, 6, 7 yards a chunk. And, you know, that was executed really well. And, you know, it's something that we're doing at a more consistent pace and rate, and that's really good as you get into district play.
You have to like where you're at headed into the district. Obviously, the reverse of where you were a year ago, but, you know, as well as anyone in district, things can change in a hurry.
Yeah, no question. I mean, we are in a polar opposite spot, and we talked about that this week as a team and about where we've come. It's a 1-4 start last year, and you'd say what you want. You know, last year is last year, but ultimately most of these guys were playing last year and know what it took to flip the script, and, you know, they brought that to this season. But ultimately they know, too, now, you know, you're 3-1, and really what you've done at this point doesn't matter. You got to show up now, because in a district where it looks like all 6 teams are pretty even, you're going to have to play really well every night or you'll get beat.
Homecoming this week, you got to put some of those things aside. You got a tough matchup against Heelan.
Yeah, you know, and Heelan's one of those teams that probably preseason one of the teams that's favored for our district with the quantity of guys they have coming back. And how they ended their season was similar to us, with a big win against Sergeant Bluff. And they haven't taken their foot off the throttle at all. I mean, they have an immense amount of speed, a lot of, you know, state qualifying track guys that you see on their team, and really good athletes. And, you know, they just pose a lot of really big problems for you. Their quarterback is a phenomenal athlete, probably one of the best in our district. And, you know, we face a lot of different kinds of offenses through non-district, and Heelan kind of puts it all together to run and pass, so they'll keep you on your toes, and we're going to have to do a good job of executing.
Yeah, offensively, they've put some points on the board, and like you said, pretty balanced. Quinn Olson at quarterback is a dual threat.
Yeah, you know, he is. Like I said, he's a really good athlete and probably one of the best players in our district, or is one of the best players in our district. And, you know, we let him beat us with his feet last year on the opening drive and miss a lot of tackles, and he's pretty slippery, and we'll have to do a great job of tackling him in space. There's no doubt when Heelan needs the yards, they're going to let the ball be in his hands, and deservingly so. I mean, you know, they have some big offensive linemen up front, so that's something we haven't really seen thus far, and we're going to have to fit really well and tackle well in space.
What about defense? What do they do well defensively?
Well, you know, they're similar to us, and I assume we'll get some of the same things we've got in the last few weeks, where teams are going to pack it in the box on us and shut down a run. I mean, you'd be a bit foolish to not do that. And you know, so we've got to execute. We've got to block things up. We've got to run hard, get our 3 yards. But, you know, ultimately we've worked pretty hard on the passing game as well in the last few weeks and executed at a higher level. So, it's just going to take, you know, consistency on offense, much like we had against Spencer in the first half, and just keeping the ball in our hands so we can keep it out of theirs.
What else is it going to take for the Warriors tonight?
I think, you know, with the homecoming thing, I think our guys will do a great job of keeping it all in perspective. And when the Hamlet goes on, it's about the game, and they understand the situation here and how we're starting off district play with one of the best teams in our district, and they've got to show up. It's a home game. There'll be lots of people. And so I would say, you know, our biggest key is just focus. It's just focusing on our task and what we need to do. And, you know, we talked offensive defense, and it always goes back to special teams for me. We got to focus there. You know, we gave up a kickoff last week for a touchdown. You can't do that in a big game. And you'll find that you're behind at the end if you do. So we need to execute in every phase and be very consistent and just focus on what our task is.
Thanks, Tim. Good luck tonight.
Thanks, Doug.
Sioux Center Coach Tim Van Riggenmoerter joining me on tonight's pregame show. We'll hear from Heelan Coach John LaFleur after this timeout. You're listening to High School Football on Sioux Ritmo 101.5.
When it's time to choose a bank, the choice is easy. Prime Bank is the bank for you.
With all the conveniences you want in a bank, including a mobile app and online account opening, Prime Bank also offers you pick checking with no monthly fees or minimum balances. And the best part is, you get paid for everyday banking transactions. That's right. Prime Bank's you pick checking. We pay you for your everyday checking account transactions.
Choose Prime Bank. It's the bank for you. Earn more your way with Prime Bank.
Member FDIC.
At Sioux Center Health, our mission is to bring hope, health, and healing to life. Being healthy is more than just exercising. It's experiencing everything that life has to offer and ensuring you continue to do what you love. Our family medicine providers are here to serve you and your family through all stages of life, providing you with care to stay healthy and a focus on your total well-being. For every checkup, for every doctor visit, our family medicine providers are here to serve.
There are certain things you can count on with local sports. Great plays, close calls, and our student athletes leaving it all on the field. There are also things you can count on when it comes to physical therapy. When you make proactive physical therapy your choice, you'll get great care and optimal outcomes from PT experts with over 35 combined years of physical therapy experience and over 20 years of athletic training services to area athletes. So while you take care of business out there, we'll take care of business in here. Make proactive your choice to get active and stay active.
At Premier Communications, we're all about connection, connecting you to all the entertainment, work, and family you love with our phone, internet, cable TV, and tech support services. And now, that connection has gotten even faster with internet speeds up to 1 gig. Experience the next level of connection with Premier Communications. Visit us online at mypremieronline.com or call toll-free 800-741-8351. Premier Communications, looking ahead.
Heelan Coach John LaFleur joins me on tonight's pregame show. And Coach, heading into the district opener, the Crusaders have won each of your four games. You have to be pretty pleased with what you've seen from your team overall up to this point.
Absolutely. It's been a good season so far. Kids have responded really well to what we've wanted to do. And you know, it's we're trying to take it one game at a time and realize that we have a really large, difficult opponent in front of us tonight.
Coming into the season, coming off a two-win season a year ago, what things did you focus on heading into this year? What are some of the differences you've seen in your squad so far?
Well, number one, we have a really nice senior class that has shown a lot of grit, character, integrity, all those words fall after those guys. They've been able to stick to it through 3 years of pretty tough times. Says a lot about those kids. And they've bought into the idea of focusing on fundamentals and just doing all the little things right. And, you know, so far, so good this year.
Who are some of the guys that are your leaders this year?
Well, we've got Quinn Olson, who's our quarterback. He probably starts there with him, and he's moved over to playing safety on the defensive side of the ball this year as well, and has been really effective on both sides. We've got Ricky Soto, has been our kind of our top running back this so far this year, and then he also plays linebacker as well. Max Delaney's been a nice, has really shown up this year pretty well as an outside linebacker and as a fullback. And you can go down the line, there's a lot of those kids, and you can see that there's a lot of them that play both ways. We're not blessed with a tremendous amount of depth, but what we have is some kids that play hard and play a lot of the ball game.
From an offensive standpoint, you've been able to put some points on the board. What has contributed to that success? What have been some of your strengths on the offensive side?
Well, I think running the ball. Obviously, you can look at our stats and see that we have not thrown the ball a lot. We've been effective when we've thrown the ball, but we have not thrown the ball a lot. But we've made an emphasis on wanting to be able to run the ball and try to control the clock, and that's I've been happy with their progress so far. We're a long way from a finished product, but we're getting there.
From a defensive standpoint, it looks like you've been able to limit the opponent's ground game.
We have, and that has to be an emphasis. I think any type of football you play, defense, we got to be able to stop the run. We're going to have our hands full with that with Sioux Center because they like to strap it up and come right at you. So it'll be interesting to see how effective we can be in stopping their really solid ground attack.
Heading into the district opener tonight, you get things started with Sioux Center. What are some of the things that stand out to you about Sioux Center's team overall?
Well, I think they're very similar to us, but maybe even more talented. Pretty senior heavy with some outstanding players. Number 40, Carson Brown, obviously everyone knows about. Great player, huge size, presents a huge mismatch for us. Quarterback Van Rigamorter has been very effective, good athlete. And then number 23, his name escapes me for a minute, but boy, he's a tough running back that will punish people. When he has the opportunity, and those guys all along with multiple others and a very large offensive line, it's going to present a huge challenge for us.
As you talked about Sioux Center's offense, as you break things down from a defensive standpoint, what are some of the keys for Heelan on that side of the ball tonight?
Well, we're going to have to try to get them off schedule. They do things, they'll come out and get in a formation and run it over and over and over again, and usually they're pretty effective on that. And we can get them off schedule, get them behind the chains, so to speak, and then they might have a chance to be able to stop them.
What do you feel like Sioux Center's strengths are on the defensive side? What has to happen for Heelan on offense?
Well, they're so dynamic with their different linebackers coming from different directions at all times. We're going to have to be very sound with our alignment or with our checks to who we're blocking and when we're blocking when they have different linebackers blitzing from different directions at all. But the 3-5 or 3-4 defense that they run presents some major challenges and something that we haven't seen yet this year.
What other things do you want to see from your squad in this one? What's the focus?
Well, the focus is just always winning the next one, and we need to get better. We've been focusing on that in practice this week about just getting back to fundamentals, not losing sight of what the little things are, and not just focusing on game plan only, but focusing on the little things. And they can continue to do that. We'll have an opportunity to be in every ball game and hopefully compete.
Thanks, Coach, for taking the time to visit. We appreciate it.
You bet. Thank you, Doug.
Been visiting with Heelan coach John LaFleur on tonight's pregame show. We'll have more from Open Space Park after this timeout. You're listening to High School Football on Sioux Ritmo 101.5.
Sioux County Radio and the Dort Media Network are excited to announce that every Sioux Center home football game will be brought to you over Dort Media Network's multiple camera system.
Throwing and making a catch, it's a touchdown.
Great video along with the voices you know from Sioux County Radio. Sioux Center Warrior Football, home and away, broadcast in English on Sioux Ritmo 101.5 FM.
The games, the scores, the players, and the plays. From the opening kick to the game-winning touchdown, we've got it all covered Saturday mornings at 9 on Coffee with the Coaches from the Fruited Plain Cafe on Main Avenue in Sioux Center. Keep up to date on your favorite team. Coffee with the Coaches streams live on SiouxCountyRadio.com, courtesy of Touch of Hope. Coffee with the Coaches, Saturday mornings at 9 from the Fruited Plain Cafe in Sioux Center on the voice of Northwest Iowa Sports, 93.9 KSOU.
Thank you for watching this Dort Media Network Sioux Center High School Warriors live stream broadcast, produced by the students of Dort University.
Our 8-inch chocolate chip cookie or 4 20-ounce bottles of Coke, offered for carryout only at Pizza Ranch for a limited time. Go to pizzaranch.com to order yours today.
Pizza Ranch.
Did you know People's Bank is a top lender for the first-time homebuyer program? We have everything you need, from low rates to grant money to even programs that do not require a down payment. Hi, this is Mike Dieger from People's Bank. We have helped many customers make buying their first home a reality, and we would love to help you. We'll walk you through the entire process from getting pre-approved all the way to closing day. Stop in to apply or visit us online at peoples-emortgage.com. People's Bank, where values matter. Member FDIC, equal housing lender.
John LaFleur at quarterback is Quinn Olson. The running back, Ricky Foto and Joey Fitzsimmons. At wide receiver, George Sabanos and Sir Brandon Watts. The tight end will be Cannon Bork. On the offensive line, at left guard, Logan Gray. The center, left tackle is Hayden Overgaard. And then Logan Gray at left guard. The center is Sam Van Holland. Right guard, James Cleary. And the right tackle is Augustine Moreno. Defensively for the Crusaders, the defensive ends will be Cannon Bork and James Cleary. At nose tackle, Hayden Overgaard. Linebackers will be Max Delaney, Kaysen Thomas, Joey Fitzsimmons, and Ricky Foto. The corners are Sir Brandon Watts and Jack Schramm, and the safeties, George Sabanos and Quinn Olson. For the Sioux Center Warriors, and head coach Tim Van Regenmorter. At quarterback, Brody Van Regenmorter. He's a 6 foot, 190-pound senior. Wide receivers will be Cole Hoyer and Cale Van Beek.
And running back Connor Cameron and Seth Anderson. Carson Brune is the tight end. On the offensive line at left tackle, Zach Porin. At left guard, Chase Huizinga. At center, Freddie Hernandez. The right guard, Jack Crane. And the right tackle will be Cullen Juisty. Defensively for the Warriors, defensive ends are Carson Brune and Gavin Vanderskaff. The nose is Freddie Hernandez. Linebackers will be Seth Anderson, Connor Cameron, Abe Hibma, Reed Hulsoff, and Solomon T. The corners are Cade Bauer and Isaiah Else, and the free safety is Cole Hoyer. As we get set to go for football on this Friday evening, it's overcast, and there is a chance for showers, maybe a thunderstorm during the course of the night. No lightning or anything like that at the moment. And we'll get this game underway without a hitch here tonight in Sioux Center. The officials for tonight's game, the referee, Marlo Van Ginkle. The umpire, Jake Anderson. The headlineman is Tim Snyder. The line judge will be Brent Ripperdep. The back judge is Sean Creeman. Having the coin tosses, we get set to go for this one. One halftime score to report. Boyden Hall Rock Valley leading Sergeant Bluff Luton 13-3. That's also in Class 3A District 1. That game kicked off at 4 this afternoon. Also, 5 o'clock kickoffs in Class 2A District 1. West Lyon at Western Christian and Sheldon at Unity Christian. Those are our other two broadcast games tonight on Sioux County Radio. Looking ahead to tomorrow, we've got Northwestern College football tomorrow night in Yankton, South Dakota, as Northwestern takes on Marty. That'll be a 7 o'clock kickoff, pregame at 6:30. Dort football team is in their bye week. They're off tomorrow. We'll have Dort volleyball tomorrow afternoon as the Defenders play a GPAC match at Concordia, and that's, I believe, a 3:30 contest tomorrow afternoon on Hawk Country 106.9 KIHK. We're just about set for the kickoff for this one. Glad to have you along tonight on Sioux Ritmo 101.5 and online at SiouxCountyRadio.com. Also on the Dort Media Network. And a shout out to the Dort Media Network crew as they bring the video coverage to you. Sioux Center will kick off to start this contest tonight. Back deep to receive for Heelan is Sir Brandon Watts. He's a playmaker for the Crusaders, averaging 12 yards per kickoff return for Heelan. As Sioux Center will kick to get this game underway. And here we go. End over a line drive kick. And it's taken on the fly at the 20-yard line. And the Crusaders will return. George Sabanos brings it out to near the 40-yard line. So good field position by Heelan to start this contest with 11:56 left to go in the first quarter. We'll get our first look at the Crusader offense, led by senior quarterback Quinn Olson. He goes 6'3", 190. He's a two-time honorable mention all-district player. And the Crusaders have it first and 10 at their own 38-yard line. Olson out of the shotgun. A couple of wideouts to the left. Now a man in motion going left to right. Back to throw is Olson. Warriors looking to get pressure. Olson throwing on the run. Completes the pass to Sabanos for a first down all the way to the 41-yard line of Sioux Center. Solomon T makes the stop, but that's a 20-yard pickup for Heelan on the pass play to Sabanos. So it'll be first and 10 for the Crusaders in Sioux Center territory at the 41-yard line. And Olson, a quick swing pass to the near side. The tight end, Cannon Bork, he's wrapped up. He's across the 35 and down to the 33-yard line.
as on the stop for the Warriors, Cole Hoyer. And it'll be second and short, second and three. So the Crusaders coming out, throwing the football. And they're in business here on their opening possession at the Sioux Center 33. It's second down and two. Out of the gun again is Quinn Olson. One running back, Ricky Foto. And Foto will take the handoff. Tripped up in the backfield. Carson Brune in there for the Warriors. And he is stopped for no gain on the play. And it'll be third down and two.
Sioux Center giving up two big plays on the first two offensive plays by Heelan there. But they have a chance here to get off the field. Well, Heelan will probably go for it on fourth down here. But still a chance for Sioux Center to end the Heelan drive.
I formation now as Olson comes up under center, and he's going to run himself and brings it across. He's got a first down to the 30, maybe close to the 29-yard line. So a couple of Crusader first downs on their opening series, first and 10 at the Sioux Center 30-yard line. A Heelan team that's averaging 364 yards a game total offense. That's a big improvement over a team that went 2-7 a year ago, averaged just 204 yards per game in total offense. Football on the right hash at the 30-yard line of Sioux Center. It's first down and 10. Quinn Olson back to the shotgun with Ricky Foto in the backfield. And now Olson will give to Foto, and he is stuffed for no gain, maybe a loss of a yard on the play. Brune was in there again for the Warriors, and so was Abe Hibma. No gain on the play, makes it second down and 10. So the Warrior defense handling the run so far for Heelan. Now second and 10 at the Sioux Center 30, and back to throw is Olson. He'll swing it out and tripped up in the backfield. After making the catch, Sir Brandon Watts is dropped for a loss.
This is exactly what the Sioux Center defense needed right here. Two plays by Heelan going for negative yardage, first for no gain, and now a loss of two on the screen pass to Watts. So Sioux Center is able to force Heelan into a third and long here.
So it'll be third and 13 at the Sioux Center 33-yard line. 8:34 left to go in the first quarter, no score. Heelan on the opening possession of the contest. Olson on the option, rolling right, in trouble. And he's going to be forced out at the 40-yard line. That's a loss of at least five more yards on the play. They mark it at the 39. And it'll be fourth and long, and now for the Crusaders, and they'll probably have to punt from the Sioux Center 39-yard line. The punter is George Sabanos as the Crusaders line up in punt formation. And he'll kick it high into the air. It's floating and takes a bounce back into the end zone, I believe, for a touchback.
Sioux Center playing it safe there on that punt. They didn't even have a returner back to return that punt, nor did they send really any kind of rush after the punter there. So they were just expecting Heelan to punt that one away, but they were ready for the fake if they decided to go with that.
So Sioux Center takes over on offense with 7:38 left to go in the first quarter, no score. Heelan defense has been stingy, giving up, they give up 251 yards a game total offense, just 82.5 yards a game on the ground. It's been Reagan Mortar, the quarterback, out of the gun. Too wide to the right side, and he's back to throw on first down. Fires downfield. He's got a man. That's caught in stride at the 40-yard line of Heelan. Cade Bauer takes it all the way to the Crusader 32-yard line. First down and 10, Warriors.
Well, what a way to start the game for the Warrior offense. they look to get in on the passing game here. And yeah, Bauer just running a deep post down the middle of the field, and Brody hits him right on the numbers. And Sioux Center in business here.
That's a 48-yard pickup. First and 10, Sioux Center at the 32-yard line of the Crusaders. And now the handoff on a run, trying to get to the outside. Connor Kammerman, he's tripped up, dives forward, gets a yard on the play. It'll be second down and 9 from the 31 of the Crusaders. Brody Van Regenmorter with that big pass play coming in, pass for 419 yards, 6 touchdowns. He has not been picked off so far this year. Second and 9 at the Crusader 31-yard line. We're scoreless with 6:40 left to go in the first quarter. And straight ahead comes Connor Kammerman off the right tackle. And he's inside the 30 to about the 27-yard line of Heelan. It's going to be third down and 5. A 4-yard pickup on that last run. Warriors to the 27-yard line of the Crusaders. Now probably 4 down territory here for Sioux Center. Third down and 5. 2 wide to the right for Van Regenmorter. 2 running backs. Drops back to throw. Fires. That's caught at the 30-yard line. That's another Sioux Center first down. And that was Cale Van Beek, I think.
Nice play call for Sioux Center there. Van Beek just running his route right to the first down marker, sitting down right there in a hole in the defense. And a nice throw by Van Regenmorter. Good timing. Sioux Center picks up the first down.
So it's first down and 10 at the 21-yard line of the Crusaders. Van Regenmorter hands it off, and Solomon T. dives across the 20. He's down to the 19-yard line. Gain of 2. Solomon T had a nice night running in the win over Spencer last week. He's got 185 yards on the season, averaging about 4.7 yards per carry. Leading ground gainer is Connor Kammerman with 361 yards and 4 touchdowns. Here comes Kammerman. They try to bust him to the outside, and he is tripped up. Not much of a game. The safety, George Sabanos, makes the stop for the Crusaders. They're going to mark it at the 16-yard line, third and about 6. High school football tonight on Sioux Ritmo 101.5 is courtesy of Jerry's CarQuest, the Pizza Ranch, People's Bank, and by Rosenboom. Third and 6. And the lineup. And might have drawn Heelan offsides. One of the defensive ends, Max Delaney, jumping. And it is a 5-yard penalty on the Crusaders.
Well, that'll make this third down a lot easier for Sioux Center. Now it's about third and a foot.
Third and inches, yep, from the 11-yard line.
We'll see if they just try to sneak it here like Heelan did on their previous possession.
Here's Van Regenmorter on third and less than a yard. Straight ahead comes Connor Kammerman. He is met by the nose, Hayden Overgaard, and lost a little on the play. So it'll be fourth down from the 16-yard line of the Crusaders. To the line of scrimmage comes Sioux Center.
Heelan fully expecting a run here, loading the box.
Fourth and 1, Kammerman pounds it ahead, dives to the 10-yard line. If they mark it at the 10, that's enough.
He got there. Good second effort by Kammerman, because it initially looked like he was stopped at the line of scrimmage, but he's able to fall forward for the first down.
It is a Sioux Center first down. It's first down and goal to go.
3:34 left to go in the first quarter. We're scoreless. Each team has had one possession up to this point. As Van Riggenmorter brings the Warrior offense to the line, two wide to the right, and he fakes to T, rolling right as Van Riggenmorter looking downfield, completes a pass. That's Cale Van Beek, who spins out of bounds inside the five. It'll be second down and goal to go for Sioux Center. They're going to put this down at the two.
Great job by Van Beek to haul that pass in, and then the balance along the sidelines to be able to turn that upfield there. Looked like he was going to go out of bounds at maybe the five, but he's able to turn it upfield. And by the time he stepped out, he got about to the two-yard line.
Second down and goal to go. Sioux Center trying to break a scoreless tie. Van Riggenmorter, the backs are split behind him, and he's going to give Solomon T off the right tackle. Looks like he stopped just short of the goal line. It'll be third down and goal to go. And they spot it inside the one, a third and goal for Sioux Center. T comes off to the sideline. Boy, power run right here, right up the gut. Van Riggenmorter, one wide to both sides. He'll hand it off. Cameraman to the goal line. And no signal yet.
Looks like he fell into the end zone.
Boy, I thought he was across.
Oh, boy.
They're going to mark it short.
This is like the one, not even 1 foot. This is like 6 inches. Holy cow.
Fourth and goal for Sioux Center. Seth Anderson comes in from the sideline for the Warriors.
Sioux Center has to punch this in here.
Van Riggenmorter out of the shotgun. Cameraman the lone running back. And Van Riggenmorter, Coach Van Riggenmorter on the sideline asking for a timeout. And it's granted. So fourth and goal coming up for Sioux Center with a scoreless tie. 1:49 left to go in the first quarter. We'll take a 30-second timeout. You're listening to High School Football on Sioux Ritmo 101.5.
Being the hands and feet of Christ. Since its inception in 1979, Justice for All has strived to serve those in need. Whether it be through the distribution locally or nationwide of donated household goods, clothing, and other items, or with its service and learning trips across North America, JFA strives to provide opportunities, build relationships, and redistribute resources through caring and sharing in Christ's name. To learn more about Justice for All's programs and how to get involved, visit online or call 712-476-2804.
Out of the shotgun, Connor Kammerman is the running back. Tight formation to the line of scrimmage. The snap to Van Riggenmorter, hands to Kammerman, and he's across. Touchdown, Warriors. Connor Kammerman with a 1 yard touchdown run. Sioux Center has 6 on the board. It comes with 1:48 left to go in the first quarter.
Great job by the Warrior offensive line there. And Carson Bruin, too. The line of scrimmage right there looked like it was right at the goal line. And then Bruin just came in and created a nice little pocket there for Cameraman to barrel into the end zone.
Extra point try for Enrique Felipe. Good hold. The kick is blocked. The kick is blocked, so it's no good. But Sioux Center put 6 points on the board. It's 6-0 Warriors with 1:48 left to go in the first quarter. We'll be back in a minute. You're listening to High School Football on Sioux Ritmo 101.5.
Today's banking is about so much more than numbers. It's about people. It's about community.
It's about the next generation. Banking is personal. That's what we believe. And that's why we'll always put you first. Northwest Bank. Commitment you can bank on.
You could just give a gift, but why? When you can give so much more. When you shop Touch of Hope Christian Book and Gift Store in Sheldon, it's not just a gift. It's blessing someone in their journey, sharing prayers, sharing faith. Come to Touch of Hope for a perfect day spring greeting card, a hooded sweatshirt, travel coffee mug, sentimental picture frames, CDs of your favorite Christian artists. We have journals, devotionals, and so much more. Visit to be inspired. Touch of Hope, locally owned and devoted to quality products and heartfelt service. 915 3rd Avenue, Sheldon.
Sioux Center is set to kick off following the scoring drive. And Heelan will bring it back across the 30-yard line. A minute 43 left to go in the first. Sioux Center 6, Heelan nothing. The Crusaders will have the ball at their own 33-yard line. So first down and 10. Nice drive by the Warriors. They go 80 yards in 9 plays. First and 10, Heelan up under center is Quinn Olson on first down, and they hand it off. Ricky Foto banging off a couple of defenders. They're brought down after a 5-yard pickup on the play. It'll be second down and 5. The first series for Heelan ended in Sioux Center territory, but they were held to a negative 6 yards rushing on that drive. Now it's second and 5 at the 38. I formation again as Olson comes up under center. Too wide to the left side. He's going to pitch the ball back. Foto cuts inside, and he's tripped up after a short gain on the play. Abe Hibma there for the Warriors. So it'll be third down. Under a minute to go first quarter. It's third and 4 for the Crusaders at their own 39-yard line.
This is a big play for the Sioux Center defense to see if they can get off the field here and get the ball back to their offense and keep Heelan's defense on the field, prevent them from getting a long rest.
Third and 4 from the 39. Back to throw. Olson steps up into the pocket, fires on the run, coming back to the football to make the catch is Ricky Foto at the Sioux Center 46-yard line, and that's a first down for the Crusaders. 15-yard pickup. So first down for Heelan at the Sioux Center 45-yard line.
Nice play by Olson there, first stepping up in the pocket and then the nice touch on the throw to hit Foto, get it right over that Sioux Center linebacker, and Heelan converts on third down.
Yeah, Warriors able to get some defensive pressure, but Olson able to work around it. Completes the pass. Now it's first and 10 as the first quarter comes to a close. Our score, Sioux Center 6, Heelan nothing. After one quarter in the books here at Open Space Park. You're listening to high school football on Sioux Ritmo 101.5.
American State Bank is celebrating our 50th anniversary, and we couldn't have made it this far without your support. For us, banking just scratches the surface. We pride ourselves in our commitment to our communities, building meaningful relationships with our customers, and doing our best to have some fun along the way. We're proud to be a locally owned and operated bank, supporting the communities we serve. Thank you for choosing American State Bank. We can't wait to see what the next 50 years have in store.
When you add up all the Wi-Fi connected devices in your home these days, you'll be surprised at how many there are and how much bandwidth they're using. Do the math. It just may add up to needing faster Wi-Fi. Premier Communications has you covered with reliable internet speeds up to 1 gig. Keep everything connected with Premier Communications. Visit us online at mypremieronline.com or call at 1-800-741-8351. Premier Communications, looking ahead.
Ball as we we start the second quarter. First and 10 at the Sioux Center 45-yard line. Quinn Olson takes the snap, hands off in the backfield. A play that goes nowhere as the Warrior defense all over the Heelan running back is thrown for a loss.
Heelan has had absolutely nothing doing here in the run game tonight. Pretty much all their offensive yards. In fact, they have negative rushing yards, so all of their offensive yards have come through the air here tonight.
I believe that was a sophomore, Kaysen Thomas, who carried the football that time for Heelan. Second down and 11 at the Sioux Center 46-yard line. And now Photo going in motion out of the backfield. They complete the pass to the left side and slipping a tackle. That's Kaysen Thomas again, and he picks up a first down on a 15-yard pass play.
Well, it looked like Sioux Center is going to be able to trip up Thomas there. That was T who had a chance at the tackle. He had a chance before the line of scrimmage even. And instead of a loss of yards there, Heelan's going to pick up over 15 yards. On that play and pick up another first down instead of a third and long.
So Kaysen Thomas with a couple of plays here. He's lined up as the running back. They're going to hand it off. Sir Brandon Watts will run with the football. Able to get to the edge. He's tripped up after picking up five. It'll be second down and five. Watts kind of hits his hand on the turf at the end of that play. He was disappointed he didn't get more yardage out of that. Second down and four at the Warrior 25-yard line. Homecoming for Sioux Center. Good crowd tonight. Second down and four. High snap. Olson has to track it down. Turns and throws and completes a pass for a first down to the 20-yard line. Cannon Bork, the tight end, with the catch. And a first down for the Crusaders. A pickup of six.
Well, great improvisation there by Olson on the snap that went through his hands. I'm not sure that Sioux Center allows that completion to be made if they're not out of position there due to the missed snap, so that ends up working out in Heelan's favor.
First down and 10 at the Sioux Center 20. Up under center, Olson will hand it off, and a straight ahead run on the left-hand side is Photo for, nope, that's Sir Brandon Watts. I wonder if Photo is hurt.
Photo just checked back in, I think.
Okay.
This is the first time he's been in the entire series.
Yeah. Inside the 20 at the Sioux Center 17. Tonight's broadcast courtesy of Mike Service Garage, DeYoung Hardware, Citizen State Bank, and the Hague Health Center. Olson comes up under center again, out of the eye. A couple of wide outs, they're going to pitch, and this is Thomas again. And he has another Heelan first down. I believe they're inside the 10 down to the 8-yard line. That's a 9-yard pickup. And a Crusader first down. That's their fourth on this drive. And it's first down and goal to go for Heelan. Thomas once again, the running back. Quinn Olson takes the snap, turns, hands it off. Thomas trying to counter to the right side, maybe a yard that time, not a lot. It'll be second down and goal to go. Kaysen Thomas, a 6'1", 190-pound sophomore. Did not have a ton of carries up to this point. Here we go, second and goal. Thomas bobbles the ball as he takes the handoff. His momentum carries him forward back to the line of scrimmage, maybe a 1-yard pickup on the play. But now it's going to be third and goal from about the 7-yard line.
Got to think we're going to see Heelan try to throw the ball here on third and goal. They haven't been able to really pick up any yardage in this goal-to-go series here, so I have to think they're going to try to take a shot at the end zone through the air.
Third down and goal from the six. Kaysen Thomas, the sophomore, coming into the game, 14 carries for 51 yards on the season. And he's got four carries all this series for the Crusaders. Third and goal from the 7-yard line. Back to throw, the quarterback Olsen to the end zone. It's broken up, incomplete. And it'll be fourth down. That's the first incomplete pass thrown by Heelan, quarterback Quinn Olsen tonight. He'd been a perfect 5 for 5. Now it's fourth and goal, and the Crusaders are going to attempt a field goal. So this will be a 23-yard field goal try for George Sabanos. He's kind of a do-it-all kind of guy for the Crusaders. The kick is up, and it is no good. Wide to the left. So the field goal try is no good. Heelan comes up empty, and Sioux Center will get the football back. Still 6-0 in favor of the Warriors. 7:15 left to go in this first half. High school football on Sioux Ritmo, courtesy of Northwest Iowa Community College, Prime Bank, Sioux Center Health, Fairway, and by the Bargain Alley Thrift Store.
That's a big stand for the Warrior defense there to not be able or to give up not any points there on a goal-to-go situation. First and goal Heelan had from the 8-yard line, and they didn't give up any points there. That's huge for the Sioux Center defense.
First and 10 Warriors from the 20-yard line. 7:15 left to go until halftime. Here's the snap, and Reagan Mortar hands it off. Warriors off left tackle and a couple for Connor Kammerman. No, that was Seth Anderson off the left side for about 3 yards.
This is also Sioux Center's second drive of the game, only 7 minutes to go here in the second quarter, and they're only touching the ball for the second time this game.
Ball control offense for both sides. Second and 7 from the 23. And Reagan Mortar with the snap will pitch to the near side. That's Anderson. Anderson rolled down across the 25 near the 28-yard line. That was Sir Brandon Watts on the tackle. And it'll be third down and just a yard to go from the 29. So third and 1 from the 29-yard line. And up the gut, diving across the 30 for what appears to be a Warrior first down is Seth Anderson. First down for the Warriors. So they move the sticks from the 31-yard line. 6-0 in favor of Sioux Center. 5:47 left to go in the first half. Coming up, the Hy-Vee halftime report. Here's play action. Van Regan Mortar throwing and just out of the reach of his diving target, Cade Bauer. That's the first incomplete pass thrown by Van Regan Mortar. There's a flag back at the 24-yard line. So flag on the field.
Looks like holding on Sioux Center.
Yeah, holding on the Warriors. That's the second penalty of the game for Sioux Center, I believe. So now it's first and 20 from the 21-yard line. And
up the middle on the carry for Sioux Center. Connor Kammerman dives across back to the 25, 26-yard line. Well, that was Ben Riggenmorter, who kept it himself. It's about half of it back on a 5-yard gain, second and 15 from the 26-yard line. 6-0 Sioux Center, down to 5 minutes left to go in the first half. Two wide to the left side, Van Riggenmorter. And he drops back looking to throw, getting some pressure, steps up, finds a man in the middle, and Cole Hoyer slips through the defense for a first down. Yards after tackle, about 10 for Cole Hoyer, and a first down for the Warriors out to the 45-yard line. That's a 19-yard pickup.
What a nice play by Van Riggenmorter and Hoyer there to be able to work around the holding penalty, which is usually a drive killer. And, yeah, Van Riggenmorter, the pocket awareness, steps up and keeps his eyes downfield. Hoyer finds the open spot in the defense and then picks up the 10 yards after catch, and he's able to pick up the first down.
First and 10 from the 45, Sioux Center's football. Here's Solomon Tino. They fake the tee. The pitch comes back to Anderson, and Anderson works his way to about the 49-yard line. A gain of 4 on the play. We'll make it second and 6. 4 minutes left to go, first half. 6-0 in favor of Sioux Center. Ball control has been the name of the game on offense. Both teams have had a couple of big pass plays, but control the ball, keep the clock moving, and off left tackle, Solomon T rumbles his way ahead to the 46-yard line of the Crusaders. That's a 5-yard gain. It'll be 3rd and 1. So it's 3rd and 1 coming up for the Warriors at the 46-yard line of the Crusaders. Split wide to the right is Cole Hoyer. Two backs in the backfield for Van Riggenmorter. He'll hand it off. Solomon T waits for the hole to open up. And there wasn't much of one, but he takes it left side for a pickup of 2, and that's a Warrior first down. First down and 10, Sioux Center. This is already 9 plays on this series for Sioux Center. That started with 7:15 left to go in the first half. They've already used up almost 5 minutes of clock. First and 10 at the Crusader 45. And Van Riggenmorter fakes the handoff, pump fakes as he looks left, now scrambling in trouble, avoids a sack at the 50, and now he's dropped, still lost a couple of yards as he's brought down at the 47-yard line. Quinn Olson there making the stop for the Crusaders, and it'll be second down, 2nd and 12. Second down and 12. Sergeant Bluff Luton and Boyden Holrock Valley. Sergeant Bluff Luton wins in overtime, 26-23 from the Van Bruggen Wesselink Insurance Agency Sports Desk. Sioux Center wants a timeout. There's a minute 37 left to go until halftime. It's 2nd and 12 for Sioux Center at the Heelan 47. We'll be back in a minute. You're listening to High School Football on Sioux Ritmo 101.5.
When it's time to choose a bank, the choice is easy. Prime Bank is the bank for you.
With all the conveniences you want in a bank, including a mobile app and online account opening, Prime Bank also offers you pick checking with no monthly fees or minimum balances. And the best part is, you get paid for everyday banking transactions. That's right, Prime Bank's You Pick Checking. We pay you for your everyday checking account transactions.
Choose Prime Bank. It's the bank for you. Earn more your way with Prime Bank.
Member FDIC.
Every story has a beginning, and this is one you will never forget. Sioux Center Health's Birthing Center is a place where families start new lives and babies are welcomed into the world in a place with all the comforts of home. From prenatal to postpartum care, we are here for you, caring for you and your family. We do this because we have families of our own. When you are ready for a baby, Sioux Center Health is here to serve.
Flags, couple of flags on the play. His cameraman stumbles his way for a gain of five. Looks like this is going to be on Sioux Center. And another holding penalty on the Warriors. The second holding penalty of the series will push Sioux Center back to their own 43-yard line. High school football on Sioux Ritmo 101.5, courtesy of Jerry's CarQuest, the Pizza Ranch, People's Bank, and Rosenboom. 6-0 Sioux Center, a minute 30 left to go in the half. From the 43-yard line, second and 22. And Riggin Mortar will hand the ball off. Cameraman, right side, plows ahead for a gain of four. And now Heelan is going to take a timeout. I think Heelan called it. It'll be third and long for Sioux Center with a minute five left to go until halftime. We'll take another one-minute break. You're listening to High School Football on Sioux Ritmo 101.5.
Self-checkout or online ordering and save curbside pickup, it's Fairway. When you want friendly in-store staff to help you find weekly specials Monday through Saturday, it's Fairway. When it comes to the freshest, fastest, friendliest for your family, there's no way it's anyway but Fairway. Your Sioux Center Fairway, online at fairway.com.
Sioux Center at the Warrior 47-yard line. Van Riggenmorter with Solomon T at running back. Van Riggenmorter will fire downfield, and a diving grab made by the Warriors. Cade Bauer for a first down. Long pass play. Van Riggenmorter hooks up with Bauer to the 24-yard line of the Crusaders. A 32-yard play. Van Riggenmorter now on first and 10, rolling right, looking, and he has to throw it away. So Cade Bauer has had two long pass plays. First for 48. And now one for 31. It's second. Well, there's a flag. I was going to say it's second and 10, but there's a flag. Another holding penalty on Sioux Center will take away 10 yards. It'll be first and 20. So that'll back the Warriors up to the 34-yard line. Heelan was looking to get the football back. That's why they used that timeout on third and long, hoping to get the ball back. Now first and 20 for the Warriors at the Crusader 34-yard line. Van Regenmorter fires across the middle. Leaping catch made by Cole Hoyer at the 20 or just inside the 20. It's going to be about 2 yards short of a first down, but a nice grab by Hoyer in traffic makes it second and three. Van Regenmorter throwing to the sideline. That is caught. And to the 11-yard line, that's a catch by Cole Hoyer. And a first down for the Warriors. So another Sioux Center first down. And now it's first and 10 from the 11-yard line. First and 10, Van Regenmorter fakes to T, fires to the end zone, and he's picked off. It's intercepted for the first time this season. And Heelan will get the football. First turnover of the night. And that interception made by George Sabanos. So Heelan has the ball back, but now just 20 seconds remain in the first half. Heelan at their own 20-yard line. Some big pass plays by the Warrior offense tonight. Heelan with the ball. Quinn Olson out of the shotgun. First and 10 from the 20. And he's going to run to the 25. And across the 30. Rolled down near the 35-yard line. A Heelan first down. As the Crusaders move the sticks. A 15-yard gain by Quinn Olson. Now 12 seconds left as Heelan takes their second timeout. With 12 seconds left to go until halftime, 6-0 Sioux Center. You're listening to High School Football on Sioux Ritmo 101.5.
¿Dónde puede encontrar colchones nuevos a una fracción del precio? Bargain Alley Furniture Outlet and Hall. ¿Cuál es el mejor lugar para donar su sofá cómoda y querida o su sillón reclinable jubilada? Bargain Alley Furniture Outlet and Hall. ¿Dónde puede encontrar nuestra tienda? Solo vaya al sur y gire en la esquina del Foreign Candy Company and Hall, donde se perfecciona la selección y siempre se aceptan sus donaciones. Compre en Bargain Alley Furniture Outlet and Hall.
Crusaders need a big play with 12 seconds left to go in the half. Quinn Olson, Sioux Center in a prevent defense, rolling right. Olson has to throw it away and try to make a pick along the sideline, Seth Anderson, but he couldn't come away with it in bounds. And now 6 seconds left, second and 10 for Heelan. So it's second and 10 from the 35. And now Heelan looks like they're going to take a knee here. And the snap, Olson takes a knee, and that'll bring us to halftime. Our halftime score at Open Space Park. Sioux Center 6, Heelan at nothing. The Hy-Vee Halftime Report is coming up. We'll take a 3-minute timeout. You're listening to High School Football on Sioux Ritmo 101.5.
There are certain things you can count on with local sports. Great plays, close calls, and our student athletes leaving it all on the field. There are also things you can count on when it comes to physical therapy. When you make proactive physical therapy your choice, you'll get great care and optimal outcomes from PT experts with over 35 combined years of physical therapy experience and over 20 years of athletic training services to area athletes. So while you take care of business out there, we'll take care of business in here. Make proactive your choice to get active and stay active.
I don't think I would be as successful as I am if it wouldn't have been for the trio staff's help, encouragement, support, just everything they do for us, always providing extra resources for us and listening to us when we need someone to listen to us as well.
The instructors here are amazing. I mean, Ken, have a question, you know, he'll be doing something with another student. Yeah, what do you need? Three instructors, I mean, I don't think I can name any other college that has as much one-on-one time as this place, so that in itself is pretty extraordinary.
Being the hands and feet of Christ. Since its inception in 1979, Justice for All has strived to serve those in need. Whether it be through the distribution locally or nationwide of donated household goods, clothing, and other items, or with its service and learning trips across North America, JFA strives to provide opportunities, build relationships, and redistribute resources through caring and sharing in Christ's name. To learn more about Justice for All's programs and how to get involved, visit online or call 712-476-2804.
You are watching the Dort Media Network, a broadcast production produced by the students of Dort University. Thank you for watching.
Not just the way they do business, it's the way they stay in business. Find them online at MikeServiceGarage.com. Comprehensive auto repair with people you trust. It's worked for them since 1965, and they're not going anywhere. Mike Service Garage, one block north of McDonald's on the frontage road, Sioux Center.
This is Marty from DeYoung Hardware, your General Electric dealer. There's more than just choosing the right capacity when it comes to buying a new refrigerator. With all of the latest features and advances, it's getting tougher and tougher to know where to begin. From measuring for the refrigerator space, including making sure the appliance will fit through the front door, to saving money with energy efficiency. DeYoung Hardware will help you better understand the options to find the perfect fit for your home. See all that's new from GE at DeYoung Hardware Hankin Hall, where we service what we sell.
Celebrate the one-year anniversary of the merge between the Brunsting Agency and the Boyden Insurance Agency with an open house September 25th from 1 to 5:30 p.m. at 817 Main Street in Boyden. Join Dan, Vonda, Mary, and Colleen as they celebrate a year of meeting new customers and growing with longtime partners and continuing the legacy of keeping business local. The open house anniversary celebration, Monday, September 25th at the Boyden Insurance Agency in Boyden.
Welcome back to Open Space Park in Sioux Center. The IV halftime report. Sioux Center leading Heelan 6-0. And for Sioux Center, just two offensive series in the first half. Heelan had two plays right at the end of the first half with just 20 seconds remaining in the half is when they took over the football. So both teams have had some long, drawn-out offensive series that took a lot of time off the clock. Sioux Center scored on its first possession of the night and drove into Heelan territory on its second possession, but that series resulted in a turnover on an interception. Heelan was turned away. They missed a field goal attempt on their second series of the night. 23-yard field goal try by George Sabanos was no good, and the Warriors lead it 6-0. Only points of the night on Sioux Center's opening series. That was a 9-play, 80-yard scoring drive. Couple of pass plays set up the drive for the Warriors. Connor Kammerman capped it off with a 1-yard touchdown run. Extra point try was blocked, and 6-0 in favor of Sioux Center. And that's where we stand at the half at Open Space Park. Sioux Center 6, Heelan nothing. first half stats coming up. The Hy-Vee halftime report is being brought to you by the Sioux Center Hy-Vee. And we'll check the stats from the first half after this from Hy-Vee. You're listening to High School Football on Sioux Ritmo 101.5.
When you're sick, you need a pharmacy you can trust.
And when you're well, you need a reliable pharmacy to help keep you that way. The pharmacists at your Sioux Center Hy-Vee are happy to be a part of your health team. Find out how easy it is to stay on top of refills with the automatic repeat refill program. And if you're on the go, they've got a convenient drive-through window, even a free prescription delivery service available. Plus, as always, your Sioux Center Hy-Vee offers immunization services to keep you protected and one step ahead of whatever might be ailing you. You'll always find a helpful, healthy smile at the pharmacy of your Sioux Center Hy-Vee.
Sioux Center 6, Heelan nothing. The first half totals for Sioux Center, 174 yards in total offense. 38 yards rushing, led by Seth Anderson with 15 yards on four carries. Connor Cameron has 10 yards on seven carries and a touchdown. And Solomon T with four carries for 10 yards in the first half. Through the air, Brody Van Regenmorter, 7 of 10 for 136 yards. Cole Hoyer has 3 catches for 42 yards. Kate Bauer, 2 catches for 79 yards. And Calvin Beek with a pair of catches for 15 yards in the first half. The Warriors have 7 first downs. They've been penalized 3 times for 30 yards. For Heelan, 85 yards in total offense, just 38 yards rushing, and 11 yards for the leading ground gainer for the Crusaders. That's Kaysen Thomas. Quinn Olson has completed 5 passes and 7 attempts for 54 yards. 5 different receivers have caught a pass for the Crusaders. George Sabanos and Ricky Foto each have 2 catches for 51 yards. George Sabanos with 1 catch for 21 yards and a catch for 6 yards for Connor Bork. In the first half, Heelan with 7 first downs, no turnovers, 1 penalty for 5 yards. At halftime, Sioux Center leads Heelan 6-0. The Hy-Vee halftime report. We'll have more from Open Space Park in 3 minutes. You're listening to High School Football on Sioux Ritmo 101.5.
American State Bank is celebrating our 50th anniversary, and we couldn't have made it this far without your support. For us, banking just scratches the surface. We pride ourselves in our commitment to our communities, building meaningful relationships with our customers, and doing our best to have some fun along the way. We're proud to be a locally owned and operated bank, supporting the communities we serve. Thank you for choosing American State Bank. We can't wait to see what the next 50 years have in store.
A trip to Pizza Ranch feels just like going home.
Hi, welcome to Pizza Ranch.
You can find all your favorite foods just the way you like them. Where a smile lets you know you're always welcome. And you're made to feel like family. For legendary service and a little slice of heaven, it's Pizza Ranch for the win.
When it's time to choose a bank, the choice is easy. Prime Bank is the bank for you.
With all the conveniences you want in a bank, including a mobile app and online account opening, Prime Bank also offers U-Pick checking with no monthly fees or minimum balances. And the best part is, you get paid for everyday banking transactions. That's right, Prime Bank's U-Pick checking. We pay you for your everyday checking account transactions.
Choose Prime Bank. It's the bank for you. Earn more your way with Prime Bank.
Member FDIC.
You could just give a gift, but why? When you can give so much more. When you shop Touch of Hope Christian Book and Gift Store in Sheldon, it's not just a gift. It's blessing someone in their journey, sharing prayers, sharing faith.
Come to Touch of Hope for a perfect day spring greeting card, a hooded sweatshirt, travel coffee mug, sentimental picture frames, CDs of your favorite Christian artists. We have journals, devotionals, and so much more. Visit to be inspired. Touch of Hope, locally owned and devoted to quality products and heartfelt service. 915 3rd Avenue, Sheldon.
The games, the scores, the players, and the plays. From the opening kick to the game-winning touchdown, we've got it all covered Saturday mornings at 9 on Coffee with the Coaches from the Fruited Plain Cafe on Main Avenue in Sioux Center. Keep up to date on your favorite team. Coffee with the Coaches streams live on SiouxCountyRadio.com, courtesy of Touch of Hope. Coffee with the Coaches, Saturday mornings at 9 from the Fruited Plain Cafe in Sioux Center on the voice of Northwest Iowa Sports, 93.9 KSOU.
Thank you for watching this Dort Media Network Sioux Center High School Warriors live stream broadcast, produced by the students of Dort University.
Nothing. It's homecoming, and the Sioux Center Marching Band performing here at halftime. Some scores to pass along from the Sioux County Radio Van Bruggen Wesselink Insurance Agency Sports Desk. A final, it was Sergeant Bluff Luton beating Boyden Hall Rock Daly 26-23 in overtime. In the fourth quarter, Unity Christian leads Sheldon 50-12. Also in the fourth quarter, West Lyon leading Western Christian 13-3. At halftime, Marcus Meriden Cleghorn Remsen Union is in front of Sibley Ocheden 12-0. And at halftime, Spencer and Lamars are tied at 7. A couple of other scores rolling in here at half, 21-0. Marcus Meriden Cleghorn Remsen Union. Alta Aurelia leading South O'Brien at the half, 31-13. Some first quarter scores. Central Lyon, George Little Rock in front of Cherokee, 18-7. West Sioux leading Maple Valley, Anthonoto, Charter Oak Ute, 13-0. And it's Spirit Lake leading Okoboji, 21-0. And that's a scoreboard update from the Van Bruggen Wesselink Insurance Agency Sports Desk. Taking a look at our sports broadcast schedule yet tonight over on 93.9 KSOU, the Iowa High School Football Scoreboard Show from 10 to 11:30. All the scores, highlights, and reports from games across the state tonight. Tomorrow, be sure to join us from the Fruited Plain Cafe on Main Avenue in Sioux Center for Coffee with the Coaches beginning tomorrow morning at 9. And then we'll have college football. Let's take a look first. College volleyball tomorrow afternoon as Dort plays at Concordia on Hot Country 106.9 KIHK and streaming online at SiouxCountyRadio.com, courtesy of Farmers Mutual Insurance Association of Hulf. That's a 4 o'clock match in Seward, Nebraska, Dort and Concordia. Pregame show at about 3:50. Then college football tomorrow evening on 93.9 KSOU. Northwestern plays at Mount Marty, 6:30 pregame, 7 o'clock kickoff from Yankton. And here on Sioux Ritmo, 101.5 Iowa's at Penn State. That's a 6:30 kickoff. And pregame coverage begins at 4:30 tomorrow afternoon, Iowa at Penn State in Happy Valley. So that's what's coming up on our broadcast schedule tomorrow. You're up to date on scores from high school football around the area tonight. Here at halftime, Sioux Center leads Sioux City Heelan by a score of 6-0. We'll take another 3-minute timeout on the Hy-Vee Halftime Report. You're listening to high school football on Sioux Ritmo 101.5.
Es un premio para los cazadores de ofertas y un paraíso para los tacaños. Bargain Alley Thrift Store and Hall. Hay montones de ahorros en ropa desde bebé hasta adulto en todas tallas y temporadas. Obtenga pequeños electrodomésticos de cocina a precios increíbles y encuentre decoración de hogar fabulosa a una fracción del precio. Si te encanta la búsqueda de ofertas, traerás un montón y ahorrarás en todo. ¡Compre ya! Martes a jueves de 9 a 5, viernes de 9 a 4 y sábados de 9 a 2. Los hallazgos son el doble de agradables a la mitad del precio en Bargain Alley Thrift Store en el centro de Hall.
Scotty here to remind you that it's that time of year again. It's Jerry's CarQuest Auto Parts Fall Filter Sale. Save 40 to 50% on all of your heavy-duty filters. Filters for your combines, cutters, trucks, tractors, or whatever heavy-duty piece of equipment you might have. All of our heavy-duty filters are made by Baldwin, so you can be rest assured that there is quality in every filter that you are putting on. And don't forget about our huge inventory of heavy-duty truck parts. Brakes, drums, brake cans, brake valves, and much more. That's Jerry's CarQuest Auto Parts, Highway 18, Rock Valley.
Pizza Ranch is celebrating the summer of chicken. On our buffet or on the go, we have the country's best chicken and the summer's best chicken, too. It's perfect for park picnics, pool parties, ping pong, putt-putt, pedal pushing, play practice, picture painting, picking peppers, and probably plenty more.
Celebrate the summer of chicken with $5 off a 12-piece chicken box. Available for carryout or delivery from your local Pizza Ranch. Pizza Ranch, everyone's favorite buffet.
Hi, I'm Jeff Oudersma from People's Bank. Are you searching for a first home or a home that better fits your needs? We are ready to help you make this a reality. People's Bank offers many mortgage packages that can be tailored to accommodate your specific home needs. Plus, qualified borrowers can receive up to $5,000 in grant money. Stop in and visit with a mortgage expert at one of our locations today or visit us online at peoples-emortgage.com. People's Bank, where values matter. Member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Calculating a career move? There's a lot to consider, like the commute to work. When you work at Rosebum, it's right down the road in Sheldon and Spirit Lake. Then there's salary. A career at Rosebum gives you the earning potential of $50,000 or more in the first year. Add in the amazing incentives and employee benefits, and all of that equals one satisfying and rewarding career. Working for Rosebum really does add up. Find out more today at rosebum.com. Rosenbum, where people matter. Equal opportunity employer, including veterans and those with disabilities.
Out onto the field as we get set for the start of the fourth quarter. One other final score, Ray in Class A, District 1, Akron Westfield over Galen Catholic, 36-7. And all of the teams, we've reached the midway point now of the football season for classes 3A and up, and coming into the night, all of the other classes are reaching the midway point with four games under their belts and four to go. For 3A and up, of course, nine regular season games, so we're halfway exactly here at halftime of this contest tonight. Sioux Center leading Heelan 6-0. Also in Class 3A District 1 tonight, MOC Floyd Valley is at Carroll. And Sergeant Bluff Luton beat Boyden Holrock Valley in overtime 26-23. We'll be set for the second half kickoff and the start of the third quarter coming up in 1 minute. Let's check that. A three-minute timeout. Third quarter coming up. You're listening to High School Football on Sioux Ritmo 101.5.
Today's banking is about so much more than numbers. It's about people. It's about community. It's about the next generation. Banking is personal. That's what we believe. And that's why we'll always put you first. Northwest Bank. Commitment you can bank on.
At Sioux Center Health, we specialize in your care.
From total knee replacement surgeries to complex diagnostic imaging tests, you can find it all here. With a professional staff and modern amenities, we care for you throughout your journey. Best of all, we put your family first, so you can be close to the ones you love. And they can be close to you. When you need specialized care, there is no better place to turn to than Sioux Center Health.
The games, the scores, the players, and the plays. From the opening kick to the game-winning touchdown, we've got it all covered Saturday mornings at 9 on Coffee with the Coaches from the Fruited Plain Cafe on Main Avenue in Sioux Center. Keep up to date on your favorite team. Coffee with the Coaches streams live on SiouxCountyRadio.com, courtesy of Touch of Hope. Coffee with the Coaches, Saturday mornings at 9 from the Fruited Plain Cafe in Sioux Center on the voice of Northwest Iowa Sports, 93.9 KSOU.
And show up, rain or shine, to work the land and share the fruits of their labor with their neighbor. This harvest season, we're thankful for all the farmers tilling and sowing, plowing and growing, and creating a better future for us all. Stay safe, stay healthy, stay proud. Hague Health Center.
Facilities. Yeah, NCC has facilities. We have four residence halls that offer many options for living. Traditional dorms, suite-style apartments, and our newest residence hall featuring private bathrooms and a state-of-the-art gaming room. The Applied Technology Building is our newest classroom lab addition and is the home of our heavy equipment and maintenance and diesel technology programs. New buildings, new classrooms, new labs, and new dorms. At NCC, your success is our story.
Second half coming up from Open Space Park. Heelan will kick off, and Sioux Center will receive the third quarter kickoff to get this second half underway. 6-0 in favor of Sioux Center. 174 yards total offense for Sioux Center, 85 yards total offense for Heelan in the first half. And both defenses have been stingy against the run. Heelan with 31 yards rushing, Sioux Center 38 in that first half. Here we go, third quarter underway. Heelan kicks it away. End over end kick is through the end zone for a touchback, and Sioux Center will have it at the 20. So start of the third quarter, this is Sioux Center's only their third possession of the football game. Scored a touchdown on their first possession, were turned away on an interception in the end zone on their second possession. Heelan had a scoring opportunity but missed a 23-yard field goal try. And Sioux Center has it, first down and 10 from the 20. Brody Van Riggenmorter turns and hands the ball off and try to work through traffic, nowhere to go. And no gain on the play. It'll make it second down and 10. Second and 10 for Sioux Center at the 20. Another final Unity Christian downing Sheldon 50-14. From the Ben Bruggen Wesselink Insurance Agency Sports Desk scoreboard, back to throw is Van Riggenmorter. He fires. That's caught at the 30-yard line. Kale Van Beek with his third catch of the night goes for 9 yards, just shy of a first down. And it'll be third and one.
Nice catch by Van Beek there, but it looked like he might have lost a yard there trying to make his way back towards the middle of the field instead of just diving forward after he caught the ball. He might have been able to pick up the first down if he had done that.
See if the Warriors try to power it ahead for a first down, third and one from the 29. And they'll hand it off, and they do. They bring it across the 30 out ahead to the 32-yard line. Connor Kammerman for a Warrior first down. So it's first and 10 from about the 32-yard line. Lights are on here now at Open Space Park.
Yeah,
Van Regenmorter will hand that off. Cameraman again fighting his way ahead to near the 35-yard line. 2 or 3 yard pickup. And it'll be second down and about 7 to go. Second and 7 for Sioux Center. Turned out to be a really nice night for football. There was, of course, the threat of rain, thunder showers, but no threatening weather. And the Warrior runner is thrown for a loss here. Seth Anderson is hit almost immediately after he took the handoff and thrown for a loss of 2. Well, no gain, we'll call it. It'll be 3rd and 7 from the 34-yard line. Van Regenmorter rolls to his right, looking, this is a straight run. Van Regenmorter angles to the pylon, to the first down marker, and he's got it. Warriors move the sticks. Nice run by Brody Van Regenmorter for the first down.
Yeah, great job by Van Regenmorter there. Kept his eyes downfield, looking for a target to throw to. Wasn't able to find one, and yeah, he just angles his way upfield and gets right to the pylon before stepping out of bounds.
First and 10, Warriors at the 43, their second first down of the series. It was tripped up out of bounds there, looking at the replay, courtesy of the Dort Media Network. First down and 10. And Anderson is tripped up in the backfield for a loss. Back at the 41, Max Delaney on the tackle for Heelan. Delaney, the second leading tackler for the Crusaders. He was an honorable mention all-district pick last season. Ricky Foto is the leading tackler on the year for the Crusaders. Kaysen Thomas leads the team with 7.5 tackles for loss. A sophomore linebacker from the 42-yard line, and the Warriors will keep it on the ground. Seth Anderson up right tackle, dives across the 45, ahead to the 46-yard line. Gain of about 3, 3rd and 7.
Well, Sioux Center's definitely trying to stay committed to being able to establish their run game here. They haven't really been able to do so on this drive, but they've still been able to move the football, mostly through the air.
3rd and 7. See if they go to the air here from their own 46-yard line. And Regenmorter has had an efficient night throwing the ball. He fakes the handoff, pulls the ball back, and swings it to the right side. The pass was bobbled before the receiver was able to take it in. Cole Hoyer stopped for no gain on the play. Ricky Foto in there on the stop, and it'll be 4th down. We'll see our first punt of the football game. No. Heelan punted once in the first half. Sir Brandon Watts back to receive the kick as Kyle Coy will come on to punt for Sioux Center. And high kick angled to the left side and takes a Warrior bounce. Still in bounds up the sideline inside the 10 and downed at the 6-yard line. What a bounce for Sioux Center. And Heelan will be pinned back deep with 7:17 left to go in the third. Heelan inside the 10-yard line. We'll mark it at the 7. It'll be 1st down and 10 for the Crusaders. A fortunate bounce of the football. You never know how that thing's going to bounce, but it stayed in bounds along the sideline for the Warriors.
Both stayed in bounds and rolled about another 20
yards.
Yeah.
1st and 10 from the 7, first possession of the second half for Heelan. Quinn Olson with 4 wide receivers, now a man in motion right to left. Olson in trouble, and he has to throw it away as he is being wrapped up in the end zone.
Should be intentional grounding, I believe.
No flags, I don't think.
He was not outside the tackle box there, and there was no receiver in the area.
It's an incomplete pass, and it's second and 10. Good pressure by the Warriors on the quarterback that time. Now Quinn Olson on second and 10. One running back in the backfield. They'll hand it off and somehow getting out across the 10 to the 11-yard line. Gavin Vanderskaff laid a hand on the running back Ricky Foto initially, but he got through there somehow for a 5-yard gain. Now to the 13-yard line, that'll be third and 5.
Yeah, Vanderskaff was kind of just hanging on Foto, trying to bring him down that entire play, but Foto just kept driving his legs and picking up a few more yards there.
Third down and 5 from the 13, and the quarterback Olson on a run, and he's got a first down, a 7-yard pickup ahead to the 20. First and 10, Heelan. Well, there's a flag. So this may be coming back. Yeah, a flag back at the 14-yard line. Looks like a hold on the Crusaders. So holding on Heelan, that's just their second penalty of the game. And that'll move the ball back inside the 10 to the original line of scrimmage at the 7-yard line, third down and 10. Warrior defense looking to get a stop here and get the ball back to their offense with potentially good field position. I formation for the Crusaders. Olson is up under center, fakes the handoff, and passing to the right side, it's incomplete. Not able to bring it in, Max Delaney, and that'll be fourth down, and Heelan will be punting from their own end zone. So fourth and 10 for Heelan. On to punt is George Sabanos. Back to receive it for Sioux Center is Cole Hoyer. High school football on Sioux Ritmo, courtesy of Mike Service Garage, DeYoung Hardware, Citizen State Bank, and Hague Health Center. Shout out again to the Dort Media Network providing our video coverage tonight. High punt takes a bounce at the 40. Across the 45, still rolling at the 50 and down to the 47-yard line. But the Warriors get a stop and get the ball back with 6:02 left to go in the third quarter. 6-0 in favor of Sioux Center. Sioux Center's ball at their own 48-yard line.
Sioux Center's definitely looking to put some points on the board this drive. I don't think they want to be in a one-score game late in the fourth quarter with Heelan, especially given that blocked extra point. If Heelan scores a touchdown, they'll likely go up by one.
Two-eyed to the left side. Here's the snap, and Riggenmorter steps up in the pocket. He's in trouble, and he's going to be sacked. Brought down at the 42-yard line. Max Delaney finally able to finish him off. There's a flag on the far side. This is going on Sioux Center. Another holding penalty on the Warriors. That's their fourth holding penalty of the game. Did Heelan decline the penalty? They did. So Heelan declines the penalty, takes the play, which was a 5-yard loss, and it'll be second and 15 from the 43. Ben Riggenmorter with the single running back. He hands it off left tackle, spinning around. Seth Anderson to the 45, ahead to the 46-yard line, gain of about 3. Now it's third down and 11. 6-0 in favor of Sioux Center. Defenses have been good. Both teams have missed chances to put points on the board. Third and 11, Van Riggenmorter takes the snap. Looks right, now rolling left. Van Riggenmorter on the run into traffic with the throw. It's incomplete. Intended for Cole Hoyer, but he was double covered.
Even if he comes down with that, he was 5 yards short of the line, yep. The first down marker.
So it'll be fourth down, and Sioux Center will have to punt for the second straight possession. Tonight's broadcast on Sioux Ritmo 101.5, courtesy of Northwest Iowa Community College, Prime Bank, Sioux Center Health, and by Fairway. Fourth and 11, Kyle Coy on to punt. Here's the snap, and he gets the kick away. And we'll send Watts back to the 13-yard line to feel it. Started to the right, now cuts back to the left. Watts trying to get to the edge and is forced out of bounds at about the 23 or 24-yard line. So good coverage again by Sioux Center on special teams as Heelan takes over with 4:37 left to go in the third. 6-0, Sioux Center leading. And Heelan will have it at the 23-yard line. First and 10 for the Crusaders. Quarterback Quinn Olson is 5 of 9 through the air, completed his first 5 passes to start the game, and now he's looking to throw deep and uncovered down the field, but coming up empty with a potential big gain is the Crusader receiver, Sir Brandon Watts.
Fortunate break for Sioux Center there, as it looked like T was basically covering 2 guys down the field, and yeah, Watts was pretty much wide open there. Kind of a challenging catch as it's coming directly over his shoulder. But yeah, huge break for Sioux Center because that might have gone for a 80-yard touchdown.
Second and 10. Quinn Olson has 3 wide, split to the right side. Looking that way, pass comes underneath. Spinning catch made by Caden Lester. And he's across the 30 and ahead to the 32-yard line for a 9-yard pickup.
Heelan looking like they're trying to go quickly here. Thought maybe they were going to try to quick sneak it. They're out of the shotgun.
Third down and 1 from the 32. Drew the Warriors offsides. So an offside penalty, and that'll give Heelan the first down. Moves the ball to the 37-yard line. Now Sioux Center with their 4th penalty of the game.
Heelan basically got the entire Sioux Center defensive line jumping offsides on that play with the hard count.
First down and 10. Crusaders at their own 37-yard line. A 6-0 Sioux Center lead. And Olson in trouble. Brune not able to bring him down. Olson still on his feet, scrambling to the left, and is finally brought down at the 41-yard line after a 4-yard gain. Second down and 6. Brune had him by the shirt tail, was not able to bring him down. He avoided another tackle in the backfield by Anderson and was finally forced out of bounds by Cameraman at the 41-yard line. Second and 6. 3 minutes left to go in the third quarter. Sioux Center 6, Heelan nothing. Motion from right to left. They'll hand it off to the motion man and unable to get to the edge, but picking up positive yardage on the run was Drew Yule. And they get it to the 45. It'll be third and short. Third and two for the Crusaders at their own 45-yard line. Olson, two wide to the right. Three wide to the right, one left. Olson looking to throw, across, looking for the far sideline, and an over-the-shoulder catch is made. And all the way to the 20-yard line of Sioux Center goes Cannon Bork for a Crusader first down.
What a ball right there by Olson, dropping that right in the pocket, right over the shoulder of Els, who's playing pretty good coverage, but Olson just puts that right on the money, and a great catch, too, over the shoulder.
And Bork, I think it's Bork, still down on the far sideline. We have an official's timeout. But Heelan in business at the Sioux Center 22-yard line after a big pass play to not only get a first down but flip the field position. 6-0 in favor of Sioux Center. 2:11 left to go in the third quarter. We'll take a timeout. Back in a minute. You're listening to High School
There are certain things you can count on with local sports. Great plays, close calls, and our student athletes leaving it all on the field. There are also things you can count on when it comes to physical therapy. When you make proactive physical therapy your choice, you'll get great care and optimal outcomes from PT experts with over 35 combined years of physical therapy experience and over 20 years of athletic training services to area athletes. So while you take care of business out there, we'll take care of business in here. Make proactive your choice to get active and stay active.
Being the hands and feet of Christ. Since its inception in 1979, Justice for All has strived to serve those in need. Whether it be through the distribution locally or nationwide of donated household goods, clothing, and other items, or with its service and learning trips across North America, JFA strives to provide opportunities, build relationships, and redistribute resources through caring and sharing in Christ's name. To learn more about Justice for All's programs and how to get involved, visit online or call 712-476-2804.
Carrier, and he's ahead to the 20-yard line. A pickup of a couple will make it second down and 8. Cannon Bork with the big catch, but I think he was hurt on the play. And left the game to the sideline. So it'll be second and 8 for the Crusaders at the 20-yard line of Sioux Center. Olson is dropping back. Now he's going to try to run. Avoids a tackle. He's to the 10, to the 5, and all the way to the end zone. Touchdown, Crusaders.
Well, there's a flag down
is
in
there?
The backfield. That's going to be
holding on Heelan.
Wow.
That's a big penalty and takes 6 points off the board. We'll move the ball way back to the 30-yard line. Sigh of relief from Sioux Center fans. The market at the 29. Second and 17, second and 18. Heelan's ball, Olson. Sends a man in motion, fakes the handoff. Olson in trouble and sacked. Back at the 37-yard line, Olson goes down. Watching the replay on the Dort Media Network, and that was for Sioux Center. Was it 62 or 52?
It was
52. Six. Oh, Kevin Vanderskaff looked like
It did kind of look like a 62, but I think that was Vanderskeff.
Okay.
That was a nice drive by Cameraman, too, though. Coming on the blitz, forced Olsen to step up right into the waiting arms of Vanderskeff.
And now Olsen throwing into coverage, and it's batted down, incomplete. And it'll be fourth down. Kate Bauer back there on the coverage for Sioux Center. So is Cole Hoyer. It's fourth down for the Crusaders. So the Warrior defense, thanks with the help of a holding penalty, the Warrior defense with a couple of big plays back-to-back. And now fourth and 24 for Heelan. They're going to line up their offense. Well, they're going to line up in punt formation, and they'll kick it away. Kind of squibbed. It's bouncing, and it's going to be downed by Heelan inside the 10-yard line. So Sioux Center will take over deep in their own territory with 38 seconds left to go in the third quarter. Sioux Center still leading 6-0. So it'll be first down and 10 for Sioux Center. And they mark it at the 10-yard line. Up to the line of scrimmage. Then Riggenmorter with the snap. And he's going to throw to the near side. And that is caught at the 40-yard line. And up the sideline, finally rolled out of bounds near the 40 of the Crusaders is Cole Hoyer. 50 yards, where are they going to mark it? 46 yards to the 44 of Heelan.
Well, Sioux Center with two huge plays now, three huge plays through the air tonight. And we'll see if this is the jump start that they need to get their offense going again and punch the ball into the end zone again.
First and 10 at the Heelan 45-yard line. Connor Cameraman a burst through the line, tripped up, coming across the 40 down at the 38-yard line of the Crusaders. We'll call it a 6-yard pickup. 12 seconds left to go in the third quarter, and the Warriors are going to let the clock run out on the quarter. Our score remains Sioux Center 6, Heelan nothing. We're headed to the fourth quarter at Open Space Park. You're listening to high school football on Sioux Ritmo 101.5.
When you want the best for your family, it's Fairway. When you want the freshest meats cut to your order, it's Fairway. When you want the freshest clean produce, it's Fairway. You need the fastest help with convenient fast lane self-checkout or online ordering and safe curbside pickup, it's Fairway. When you want friendly in-store staff to help you find weekly specials Monday through Saturday, it's Fairway. When it comes to the freshest, fastest, friendliest for your family, there's no way it's anyway but Fairway. Your Sioux Center Fairway, online at fairway.com.
¿Dónde puede encontrar colchones nuevos a una fracción del precio? Farganelli Furniture Outlet and Hall. ¿Cuál es el mejor lugar para donar su sofá cómoda y querida o su sillón reclinable jubilada? Farganelli Furniture Outlet and Hall. ¿Dónde puede encontrar nuestra tienda? Solo vaya al sur y gire en la esquina del Foreign Candy Company and Hall, donde se perfecciona la selección y siempre se aceptan sus donaciones. Compre en Farganelli Furniture Outlet and Hall.
Start of the fourth quarter, it's Sioux Center 6 and Heelan nothing. Warriors with the ball, second down and 4 at the Heelan 38-yard line. 6-0, it's been that way since the first quarter. Here's the snap, and big hole to run, and running hard further into Heelan territory is Connor Cameraman for a Warrior first down.
Sioux Center's offensive line really starting to get that push downfield, driving Heelan's defensive line back. It's been a trend in the fourth quarter in their last few games.
First down and 10 again. And the Warriors keep it on the ground. Straight ahead run. And not a bad gain on first down. 3 yards straight up the gut. Photo makes the stop for Heelan. Second and 7 for the Warriors. Now at the Heelan 24-yard line. Van Riggenmorter. And he'll hand it off again. This time it's Seth Anderson working his way ahead to the 20-yard line. That's a gain of 4 or 5. Third and about 3 to go, maybe a little better than 3. At the 20-yard line, the 19-yard line of Heelan. 6-0, Sioux Center. With a score for the Warriors here would be big. Third down and 3, Van Riggenmorter turns and he fakes the handoff. Van Riggenmorter rolling right, will run for it, sliding at the 15, and that's a first down. There's a flag. Flag back at the 24, holding on Sioux Center.
Seen a lot of huge holding calls here tonight.
That's the 4th holding penalty on Sioux Center. Heelan has had a couple, and that took them out of a drive in the second half. So now it's 3rd and 11 from the 29-yard line. More like 3rd and 13 for the Warriors. See what they come up with here. 3rd and 13 from the Crusader 29. Van Riggenmorter has 2 running backs split in the backfield. Fakes the handoff, throwing for the sideline, and it's caught. Was he inbounds? He was. It's a catch down to the 1-yard line. It'll be first down and goal to go for Sioux Center.
What a throw by Van Riggenmorter there. Puts it right on the money to Van Beek. And nice catch by Van Beek, too. Gets the left foot down right along the sideline.
Cale Van Beek, 28 yards. First down, Sioux Center. First down, a goal to go. Warriors break huddle coming out to the line of scrimmage. Hammerman and Anderson lined up with Van Riggenmorter in the Warrior backfield. And it'll be Anderson taking it off right tackle. He is stopped for no gain. Second and goal for Sioux Center. Six nothing Sioux Center. 10 minutes left to play in the football game. Warriors bring it back out to the line. Van Riggenmorter out of the gun. And he takes the snap, hands it off. Seth Anderson off left tackle. Van Riggenmorter says it's a touchdown, but the officials don't give the signal. And it's going to be third and goal.
Got to think Sioux Center is just going to run this 2 more times if they have to here. I don't see any way they throw this. The ball is, again, like inside the 1-yard line, at about like the 1-foot yard line, maybe even closer than that.
Third down and goal to go. Warriors come out to the line. They'll move in motion right to left. Van Riggenmorter to Kammerman, who tries to power it in. There it is. Touchdown, Warriors.
That's the same play they ran to get the touchdown in the first half. Send the trips in motion to the left side and then run it in right behind the block of Bruin there.
Connor Kammerman with his 2nd touchdown run of the night. And it's 12-0 Sioux Center. And they're going to go for 2 here. Here's Van Riggenmorter rolling to the right, looking, and is trying to run for it. Dives for the pylon, and they got it. 2-point run. Brody Van Regenmorter. And it's a 14-0 lead for Sioux Center with 9 minutes left to go in the football game. We'll come back in a minute. You're listening to high school football on Sioux Ritmo 101.5.
Scotty here to remind you that it's that time of year again. It's Jerry's CarQuest Auto Parts Fall Filter Sale. Save 40 to 50% on all of your heavy-duty filters. Filters for your combines, cutters, trucks, tractors, or whatever heavy-duty piece of equipment you might have. All of our heavy-duty filters are made by Baldwin, so you can be rest assured that there is quality in every filter that you are putting on. And don't forget about our huge inventory of heavy-duty truck parts. Brakes, drums, brake cans, brake valves, and much more. That's Jerry's CarQuest Auto Parts, Highway 18, Rock Valley.
As the chief buffet officer here at Pizza Ranch, I get all kinds of buffet questions from guests. Here's one from Mia.
What's your favorite Pizza Ranch buffet item?
Great question, Mia. This may be cheating, but I picked them all. The pizza, the chicken, the desserts, the fresh salads, and all the sides like mashed potatoes, green beans, and corn. In fact, the sides are so good, I don't call them sides. I think they should be called middles. So come on in and get your fill of the best pizza, chicken, salads, and middles around.
Pizza Ranch, everyone's favorite buffet.
In favor of Sioux Center. Big scoring drive for the Warriors. Goes 7 plays, 90 yards. There was a big pass play of 46 yards from Brody Van Regenmorter in there. 28-yard gain from Van Regenmorter to Cale Van Beek, who has 4 catches on the night. Here we go. The kick is squibbed, played on a hop at the 30-yard line. Heelan with a return shy of the 40, and the Crusaders take over, now down by 2 scores. 8:55 left to play in the game. Sioux Center 14, Heelan nothing. Heelan at their own 37 will take over first down and 10. So now Heelan has to be in a little bit more of a hurry, perhaps, on offense.
Probably going to do a lot more throwing on these next few drives than running.
Quinn Olson out of the gun. He's got 2 wide to the left. He's going to turn and hand it off. Ricky Foto to the 41-yard line. Gets about 5. Heelan's running game has not been very effective. The Warriors have been able to shut that down. From the 43, it's 2nd and 4. Sioux Center showing blitz, and they jumped off. Offsides gives Heelan a first down. First and 10 from the 48. .8:20 left to go in the football game. Olson will hand it off. Foto trying to find room, brings it across the 50, brought down at the 49. Pickup of 3 on the play. 2nd and 7. I think the Warrior defense will give Heelan 2 or 3 yards at a crack here, if that's what they want to take.
It's going to be about 30 seconds of play if they keep doing that.
Now 1 running back, 4 wide receivers, 2 to both sides. Now man in motion right to left as Olson takes the snap, whistles. And do we have a false start on Heelan? Looks like it. Yep, false start on the Crusaders. This game has had more penalties than any game that I've seen so far this year. So it's second and 12 from the 46. Now they'll go empty backfield with Quinn Olson and five wide receivers. Warriors rush three. Olson fires down the field, and it's just off the fingertips of the big Caden Lester, who's listed at 6'3". Looks taller than that from here. Incomplete pass. Third and 12 coming up for Heelan. At their own 46-yard line, big play here for the Heelan offense. With 7:21 left to play, 14-0 Sioux Center. Third and 12 for the Crusaders. Empty backfield again for Quinn Olson. Two-step drop. He fires toward the sideline. Complete pass underneath and angling to the first down marker. I don't know if he got there. That was George Sabanos with the reception. He's going to be a yard short.
Short by a yard. Heelan's about to just go up and sneak it. Yeah, there. He didn't get it. Oh, my goodness.
Olson, the quarterback, trying to sneak it ahead. Heelan going quickly on offense on fourth and one.
Well, they're going to check here with the – they're going to measure it. Oh, they're going to give him the first down. Wow.
Oh, Isaiah Elts was right on the line looking at it, saying it should have been Sioux Center's ball. Instead, it's a Heelan first down.
Definitely a favorable spot for Heelan there, as it looked like Olson – just tripped as soon as he tried to sneak that ball ahead.
They're at the Sioux Center 42-yard line. First down and 10. Empty backfield again. Olson is getting some pressure. Avoids a sack and now throws to the sideline. Incomplete. No, it's a catch. Kaysen Thomas with a 10-yard reception. And it's another Heelan first down. So Heelan moving the sticks here. They're to the Sioux Center 33, but taking some time. There was 8:55 left to go when Heelan started this possession. We're down to 6.5 minutes left to go in the game. First and 10, Olson, Sioux Center coming with pressure. Olson fakes the handoff, is running, and has a big gain to the 10. Bumped out of bounds inside the 10 near the 5-yard line of the Warriors.
Olson has had some big runs here tonight. One of them, of course, got called back due to the hold. But yeah, he's a very elusive quarterback. He broke at least four tackles, it looked like, on that play.
First down and goal to go in favor of Sioux Center. Seth Anderson finally forced him out of bounds. Not sure why he was trying to stay in bounds there. Heelan, the clock is against him at this point. First down and goal at the Sioux Center 7. Olson will run again, and this time tripped up after he dives forward for a yard. Freddie Hernandez in there for the Warriors. Second down and goal to go. I saw that number 62 again out there. We haven't figured out who that is for Sioux Center.
It looks like Hibma. I think it might be Abe Hibma.
Okay.
I don't know why he would have switched jerseys, but I think that's him.
Second and goal, empty backfield. Olson with a pump fake. Warriors get some pressure, and he throws back towards the middle of the end zone. It was picked off. No? Yeah. Cole Hoyer winds up with the football, and it's an interception. Cole Hoyer with the play of the game defensively.
Well, that was just a poor decision by Olson there to throw that back into coverage. Nice position by Hoyer to get on the inside of, I believe that was Watts there, trying to get back to the ball.
And I thought he was just going to throw it away.
So did I. That might be the kill shot here for Sioux Center.
Sioux Center takes over with 5:23 left to go in the game. Warriors have it at their own 20-yard line. First turnover of the game committed by Heelan. First and 10, Sioux Center. And Reagan Mortar will hand it off. Solomon T. bounces off a tackle, and he's out across the 25 near the 26-yard line. Second down and 4. Coming into the game, Sioux Heelan had a plus 5 turnover margin on the year. Sioux Center was plus 2. We're even so far tonight, one for each. Second down and 4, low snap. Van Riggenmorter has to dig it out. Gets a block in front of him from T. And Van Riggenmorter maybe gets back to the line of scrimmage. That might be wishful thinking. Loss of 2. Third down and 7. 4:47 left to go in the football game. 14-0 in favor of Sioux Center. From the 23-yard line, Solomon T. again lined up in the backfield with Brody Van Riggenmorter, and he'll take the handoff, squirts through off the left tackle to the 40-yard line. Solomon T. cuts back to the outside at the 50. He could go 30, 20, up the 10, 5. Touchdown, Sioux Center. 77 yards for Solomon T.
Well, what a run by T there, breaking through the line of scrimmage there, getting to the second level, breaking a few tackles, and then the downfield blocking. Sambolt down there, Bauer down there, just everyone racing down the sideline, and then, yeah, T takes it all the way. What a huge run for T.
3 plays, 80 yards. And on to kick for the point after. Enrique Felipe, his only other PAT attempt tonight, was blocked. Here's the snap. The kick is on the way. It's good. Sioux Center extends the lead to 21-0 with 4:28 left to go in the football game. We'll be back in a minute. You're listening to High School Football on Sioux Ritmo 101.5.
Did you know People's Bank is a top lender for the first-time homebuyer program? We have everything you need, from low rates to grant money to even programs that do not require a down payment. Hi, this is Mike Dieger from People's Bank. We have helped many customers make buying their first home a reality, and we would love to help you. We'll walk you through the entire process from getting pre-approved all the way to closing day. Stop in to apply or visit us online at peoples-emortgage.com. People's Bank, where values matter. Member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Calculating a career move? There's a lot to consider, like the commute to work when you're buying and rewarding career. Working for Rosenboom really does add up. Find out more today at rosenboom.com. Rosenboom, where people matter. Equal opportunity employer, including veterans and those with disabilities.
Up the sideline and rolls out of bounds, so Heelan will get a great run by Solomon T to give Sioux Center a 3-score lead with just 4.5 minutes left to go in the game. First and 10, Crusaders, Quinn Olson from his 35-yard line. Too wide to both sides. He's going to hand this ball off to Photo, and he's tripped up after getting a first down on an 11-yard carry. It's one of the longer runs for Heelan tonight. Quinn Olson had a 15-yard run earlier, 28-yard run. And Photo is thrown down as he's hit. And that was Olson, the quarterback. He's thrown down for no gain. So it'll be second and 10 at the 47-yard line of the Crusaders. Olsen drops back. They're going to swing one out to the far side of the field across the 50 down to the 46-yard line. It's a sack and now throws back to the middle of the field. It's caught it was incomplete at the Sioux Center 41-yard line.
T delivered a monster hit on that attempted catch there. I think that was either Sabanos or Thomas trying to haul that in. And T just lowered the boom there. He's done that a few times on passes across the middle of the field this season.
Fourth and a long three, we'll call it, at the 46-yard line of the Warriors. 3:22 left to go in the game. And tonight's broadcast, courtesy of the Bargain Alley Thrift Store, Jerry's Car Quest, Pizza Ranch, People's Bank, and Rosenboom. Olsen fires, and that ball is caught by Brandon Watts. And he's got a first down. That's a gain of about 10. Vanderscaff there on the stop, but Heelan with a first down. At the Sioux Center 36-yard line, Olsen throwing it up for grabs again, and it is incomplete off the fingertips of the intended receiver. Isaiah Eltz on the coverage for Sioux Center couldn't bring it in. Max Delaney was the receiver, and he tried to make a leaping grab. It was off his fingertips, and that kind of knocked it away from Isaiah Eltz as well. So it'll be second down and 10. That stops the clock with 3 minutes to play. Sioux Center up 21-0. 3 minutes left in the game. And Olsen will run, and he's got what appears to be a first down to the 25-yard line of the Warriors. It is a first down for Heelan. And it's first down and 10. They'll empty the backfield again. Olsen out of the gun on first and 10 at the Sioux Center 25. Getting some pressure. Olsen ducks around Brune and now has to throw it away. Incomplete. Second and 10 coming up. High school football on Sioux Ritmo 101.5, courtesy of Mike Service Garage, DeYoung Hardware, Citizen State Bank, Cake Health Center, and Northwest Iowa Community College. Second and 10 for Heelan, 2:29 left to go in the game. And Sioux Center leading 21-0. Three wide left for Quinn Olsen. Empty backfield again on second and 10. Steps up in the pocket, rolling to his right. He's going to keep it himself, forced out of bounds after a gain of about 3. Quarterback Olsen has been the leading ground gainer for the Crusaders tonight. Ricky Foto coming in was the leading rusher for Heelan. And the Warriors have kept him in check.
I feel like Thomas has actually been in for more of the series than Foto has tonight. Thomas came in tonight with only 14 carries, and he's been playing the majority of the snaps at running back.
Running back this time, Olsen will swing it out over to Delaney, and he's brought down after a short gain on the play. And Reed Hulsoff there to make the tackle. It'll be fourth down. Fourth and 6 for the Crusaders. Olsen steps up in the pocket, pump fakes, and trying to run is brought down. Holsoff again brings him down at the 20, and Heelan turns it over on downs. Sioux Center gets the ball back with just a minute 33 to play with a 21-0 lead.
Nice job by Holsoff there on the open field tackle on Olsen, who's been slicing through the Sioux Center defense all night. I think they had Holsoff as a spy there because of Olsen's mobility. And yeah, the ref got in Holsoff's way initially, but he's able to get around the ref there and is able to make the tackle in the open field.
First and 10, Warriors take over at the 20-yard line. Now just a minute left to go in the football game. And Sioux Center in victory formation. Van Riggenmorter will take a knee. Also a Class 3A District 1 score. MOC Floyd Valley leading Carroll at the half, 12-10. Earlier tonight, Sergeant Bluff Luton beat Boyden Holrock Valley in overtime, 26-23. This will be the final play of the game. Second and 15 for the Warriors. Van Riggenmorter takes the snap and takes a knee. And that will do it. Sioux Center hands fourth-ranked Heelan its first loss of the season. 21-0 on homecoming at Open Space Park. Sioux Center has won four straight. They're 4-1. Heelan falls to 4-1. More importantly, the Warriors are 1-0 in the district. Heelan is 0-1. We'll be back with a recap. We'll take a three-minute timeout. You're listening to High School Football on Sioux Ritmo 101.5.
Today's banking is about so much more than numbers. It's about people. It's about community. It's about the next generation. Banking is personal. That's what we believe. And that's why we'll always put you first. Northwest Bank. Commitment you can bank on.
I chose NCC because their electrical program is absolutely incredible. Semester to semester, I never had to worry about if I was in the right classes or if I was on the right track, because they make sure you are set on the right track. All you have to do is try.
You should come to NCC as an EMS student, because we do care for our students and we want to make sure that they are prepared to take care of that patient no matter what situation they get in. And overall, NCC is just a great place to start your success.
When it's time to choose a bank, the choice is easy. Prime Bank is the bank for you.
With all the conveniences you want in a bank, including a mobile app and online account opening, Prime Bank also offers U-Pick checking with no monthly fees or minimum balances. And the best part is, you get paid for everyday banking transactions. That's right, Prime Bank's U-Pick checking. We pay you for your everyday checking account transactions.
Choose Prime Bank. It's the bank for you. Earn more your way with Prime Bank.
Member FDIC.
Watching the Dort Media Network, a broadcast production produced by the students of Dort University. Thank you for watching.
Everyone on campus is ready and willing to help. They try to make it easy to fit in and make the transition to college as smooth as possible. NCC, your success is our story.
When it's time to choose a bank, the choice is easy. Prime Bank is the right bank for you. With all the conveniences you want in a bank, including a mobile app and online account opening, Prime Bank also offers YouPick checking with no monthly fees or minimum balances. And the best part is you get paid for everyday banking transactions. That's right, Prime Bank's YouPick checking. We pay you for your everyday checking account transactions. Choose Prime Bank. It's the right bank for you. Earn more your way with Prime Bank. Member FDIC.
When you work as an ultrasound technician at Sioux Center Health, your helping hands are an extension of the healing ministry of Jesus. Join a team of friendly and knowledgeable imaging professionals who provide compassionate and comprehensive care to patients. This position is eligible for a $15,000 sign-on bonus. Apply online at jobs.siouxcenterhealth.org. Sioux Center Health, where hope, health, and healing come to life.
Welcome back to Open Space Park in Sioux Center. Final score, Sioux Center 21, Sioux City Heelan nothing. It was a defensive battle through three quarters, 6-0. Sioux Center led. A couple of big plays, a couple of big touchdown drives, and Sioux Center able to come away with a 21-0 win.
Yeah, this wasn't all that necessary lopsided of a game in terms of total yards. And it was definitely a back-and-forth game until the end of the fourth quarter, really. But, yeah, Sioux Center really was able to just do a better job in the red zone tonight. They were able to punch the ball in 2 out of 3 times on their trips to the red zone, and Heelan was 0-for-2 scoring in the red zone.
A couple of big catches coming down the stretch from Cale Van Beek and Cole Hoyer.
Yeah, Brody Van Rigemorter, I made some comments, you know, that he necessarily didn't appreciate that much about his deep balls so far this season. But he threw some fabulous deep balls tonight, and Sioux Center did an excellent job in the passing game with those deep balls.
Well, they did, and the Warriors' defense really took away the running game for Heelan most of the night.
Yeah, Sioux Center just stonewalled Heelan's running game. And, yeah, they eventually had to take there, and Olsen really did all he could. But Sioux Center did a good job in coverage, and eventually by the end of the night, they were able to bring down Olsen behind the line of scrimmage and pick up a few sacks.
To recap the scoring, Sioux Center led 6-0 at halftime. The only score on the first series of the game for the Warriors, a 9-play, 80-yard drive, capped off by a 1-yard touchdown run by Connor Kammerman. The score remained 6-0, headed into the fourth quarter. And then the Warriors got it going, scoring with 9 minutes left to go in the game on another 1-yard Connor Kammerman touchdown run. Cap off a 7-play, 90-yard drive, and a 2-point conversion run by Brody Van Rigemorter made it 14-0 in favor of Sioux Center. Heelan got the ball back and drove the field, but a Cole Hoyer interception in the end zone gave the ball back to the Warriors at the 20 with 5:23 to go, and Solomon T with a 77-yard touchdown run put Sioux Center up 21-0. Heelan gave the ball up on downs, and Sioux Center ran out the clock on a 21-0 win. Final unofficial totals, 384 yards total offense for Sioux Center, 149 yards rushing, led by Solomon T with 93 yards on 6 carries. Connor Kammerman with the 2 touchdowns finishes with 38 yards rushing. Through the air, Brody Van Rigemorter went 11 of 15 for 235 yards. And we had Cole Hoyer with 5 catches for 88 yards. Cale Van Beek, 4 catches for 52 yards. Warriors, 12 first downs in the game. They were penalized 6 times for 60 yards in the contest. Heelan, 259 yards total offense, 111 yards rushing is where they wind up. Quinn Olson, 59 yards on 12 carries, and Ricky Foto, 30 yards on 8 carries on the ground. Quinn Olson through the air, 12 of 23 for 148 yards And the Crusaders, George Sabanos, had three catches for 39 yards. Also three catches in the game for Sir Brandon Watts for just 7 yards, though, and a couple of catches from Cameron Bork for 41 yards in the contest. Heelan had 13 first downs. They were penalized 4 times for 30 yards. Both teams turned the ball over once on an interception. And Sioux Center with the 21-0 win over Heelan to improve to 4-1 on the year. 4 straight wins for the Warriors. And who do you think our player of the game tonight? Brody Van Riggenmorter?
I think so.
Yep. Sioux Center quarterback Brody Van Riggenmorter, really efficient night throwing the ball. 11 of 15, 235 yards, and helped lead the Warriors big pass completions when they really needed them. And Brody Van Riggenmorter, our player of the game. The Warriors will resume district play next week. They'll be in Hall to take on Boyden Hall Rock Valley. Heelan next Friday will be hosting Carroll in Class 3A District 1 action. So big win to get the district race started tonight for Sioux Center. Couple of other finals. It was Boyden Hall Rock Valley downing Sergeant Bluff, or Sergeant Bluff Luton downing Boyden Hall Rock Valley in overtime 26-23. MOC Floyd Valley led Carroll at halftime 12-10. Unity Christian rolled over Sheldon 50-14. At West Lyon beat Western Christian 20-3. And those are the finals we have from the Van Bruggen Wesselink Insurance Agency Sports Desk. All of the scores coming up on the Iowa High School Football Scoreboard Show over on 93.9 KSOU. From 10 to 11:30 tonight, we'll have all the scores from the area for you tomorrow from the Sioux County Radio Van Bruggen Wesselink Insurance Agency Sports Desk. So, thanks for tuning in. A happy homecoming for the Warriors as they defeat Sioux City Heelan 21-0. Shout out to the Dort Media Network. Great job providing the video coverage on our contest tonight. Thanks to Peyton Work for providing the color commentary on our broadcast. And that'll do it from Open Space Park for Sioux County Radio Sports. I'm Doug Brook. Good evening, everyone.
American State Bank is celebrating our 50th anniversary, and we couldn't have made it this far without your support. For us, banking just scratches the surface. We pride ourselves in our commitment to our communities, building meaningful relationships with our customers, and doing our best to have some fun along the way. We're proud to be a locally owned and operated bank, supporting the communities we serve. Thank you for choosing American State Bank. We can't wait to see what the next 50 years have in store.
Just give a gift, but why? When you can give so much more. When you shop Touch of Hope Christian Book and Gift Store in Sheldon, it's not just a gift. It's blessing someone in their journey, sharing prayers, sharing faith. Come to Touch of Hope for a perfect day spring greeting card, a hooded sweatshirt, travel coffee mug, sentimental picture frames, CDs of your favorite Christian artists. We have journals, devotionals, and so much more. Visit to be inspired. Touch of Hope, locally owned and devoted to quality products and heartfelt service. 915 3rd Avenue, Sheldon.
There are certain things you can count on with local sports. Great plays, close calls, and our student athletes leaving it all on the field. There are also things you can count on when it comes to physical therapy. When you make proactive physical therapy your choice, you'll get great care and optimal outcomes from PT experts with over 35 combined years of physical therapy experience and over 20 years of athletic training services to area athletes. So while you take care of business out there, we'll take care of business in here. Make proactive your choice to get active and stay active.
A trip to Pizza Ranch feels just like going home.
Hi, welcome to Pizza Ranch.
You can find all your favorite foods just the way you like them. Where a smile lets you know you're always welcome and you're made to feel like family. For legendary service and a little slice of heaven, it's Pizza Ranch for the win.